attention of southern Islamist factions, including Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula. Yesterday, a suicide bomber from Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula drove a car bomb into the Houthi-controlled hospital in the Marib province, killing at least 15 people and wounding 50 others, according to the locals. The Yemeni government has sought to keep the Houthis confined to their far north provinces by encouraging Islamist factions to move into the areas near them. After weeks of fighting, the Houthis routed them and moved on to the capital. As their control grows, they're now facing some protest. A small protest was organized in Sana'a, though organizers claimed the turnout was kept low because of the Houthi presence across the city, which kept many leaders from showing up. The Houthis claimed a deal to form a new consensus government, and government officials said they thought that would include the Houthis leaving Sana'a. So far, that doesn't seem to be panning out, and the tensions in the capital continue to rise. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts and Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts and Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts and Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. Reuters reports, Afghanistan inaugurates its first new president in a decade today, swearing in technocrat Ashraf Ghani to head a power-sharing government just as the withdrawal of most foreign troops presents a crucial test. The first democratic handover of power in Afghanistan's history has been far from smooth. The deal for a unity government was cobbled together only after months of deadlock over a vote in which both Ghani and opponent Abdullah Abdullah claimed victory. The inauguration marks the end of an era with the departure of President Hamid Karzai, the only leader Afghans have known since a U.S.-led invasion in 2001 overthrew the Taliban that had given sanctuary to Al-Qaeda. The already tight security was heightened around the capital of Kabul ahead of the inauguration for fear that Taliban insurgents might try to disrupt the ceremony or attack international dignitaries who flew in to attend. Both foreign backers and Afghans hope that Ghani and Abdullah can put aside their acrimonious election rivalry and work to improve life in a country that has suffered war and poverty for decades. The new government inherits massive problems, including fighting an emboldened Taliban that in recent months has been launching ever more aggressive attacks as foreign troops draw down. Ghani must also reset relations with the United States, which has soured in recent years under Karzai. One of Ghani's first acts as president is expected to be signing a bilateral security agreement to allow a small contingent of U.S. forces to remain to train and assist the new Afghan army and police. Karzai had refused to sign it, but both Ghani and Abdullah are in favor of signing it promptly. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. The Associated Press reports, pro-democracy protest expanded in Hong Kong on Monday, a day after demonstrators, upset over Beijing's decision to limit political reforms, defied onslaughts of tear gas and appeals from Hong Kong's top leaders to go home. And with rumors swirling, Hong Kong's chief executive, Leong Chong-ying, reassured the public that speculation that the Chinese army...
The Supreme Court's sidekick, Kid Justice, is killed by mad genius Dr. Contempto. Thousands of elderly Japanese Americans are rounded up for an internment camp's 70th reunion. And a report confirms the habitat of Bengal tigers is now down to a studio apartment in Jaipur, India. As it was once prophesied in the weekly news recap videos of old, here now it emerges before your very eyes. This is the Onion Week in Review. Local man Matthew Hunker announced this week that he has such strong brand loyalty to Mazda that he's willing to kill for the Japanese car brand. Hunker told reporters that if he hears anyone say anything negative about Mazda's cutting-edge features, or if anyone places any other car brand above the award-winning line of 2013 Mazdas, he will, quote, personally beat them to death.
You think I wouldn't slit your goddamn throat in the name of Mazda? You think I'm f***ing around? Go ahead, say something bad about the top-rated Mazda 6 or the award-winning CX-5. See what f***ing happens. I f***ing dare you.
You think I'm afraid to go to jail?
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial toll free here. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've also got Skype. You can Skype into the show. Our username there is lrn.fm. Just send a contact request. It will be approved. We'll get you on the air on whatever you'd like to discuss. Coming up, Assange the Hologram. Derek J has the story. Ian, Derek J, and Mark in the studio with a special guest, actually, to start the show out with tonight. Mark, who do we have on Skype?
Stephen Aaron Gray. Stephen, you there?
Yes, I am. How are you guys?
Very good. Now, you're also known as DJ Freaky Flow.
That's right. Yeah, for about 21 years, music has been my career, and I'd say more people in the world know me as Freaky Flow than Stephen Aaron Gray, for sure.
You've certainly got a popular Facebook page, but you actually wrote a very libertarian novel called Ant Farm that we've been talking about here on Free Talk Live.
Yes, yeah, I did. You know, it's very pro-liberty. I would say it leans anti-state, much like I do. And it sounds a little strange to my music fans that I'd write a book that has nothing to do with music, but here it is.
What was your inspiration?
You know, I think my inspiration from being on the road, you know, playing a number of different countries over the years was just taking notice of what works well for people and what doesn't. And I noticed that people are generally happier and more prosperous in environments where they're more free and where there's less government control in their lives. And, I thought about all the people that listen to my music and that maybe have no interest in anything philosophical. And I thought, how can I write a book that appeals to them and introduces these ideas of liberty to really, you know, average people and also younger people? So that was really what inspired me to write this book.
Incredible. I know that it was kind of based on the Animal Farm. I mean, it has that Animal Farm feel to it. Is that what you're aiming for?
Yeah, absolutely. That was definitely one of the main inspirations. You know, I remembered back to when I was young, and I think it was junior high, probably eighth grade. One of the forced reading pieces in government school in Canada, which is where I lived at the time in Toronto, was George Orwell's Animal Farm. And it was really the first piece of political philosophical allegory that I read, and my first introduction at such a young age to ideas that were greater than what was just literally on the page. And, as I was getting the ideas to write my book, Ant Farm, I was thinking about what's a good sort of structure that I can introduce these ideas to people that may not otherwise be interested in these ideas. And, so there's a lot of parallels between my book and his book, but there's a very different philosophy there, I think.
Now, I know you had a small publisher for the book, and that resulted in you having to do the marketing yourself.
Yeah, and most of it.
I imagine your DJ Freaky Flow business has a lot to do with marketing yourself, too. Tell me about what you've managed to do in this area of marketing and, you know, like how do these things correspond? How are they similar? How are they different? What do you do? Any tips for people that might be trying to do what you're doing?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, if you've already got if you're able to secure a deal with a small publisher, but the marketing is left up to you like it is for me, it does help to have an existing fan base somewhere, which I did through music. So I'm trying to leverage those fans who are interested in the musical things that I've been doing for years to try and get them interested in things that are a little more, I don't want to say intellectual, because my book isn't a heavy intellectual piece. It's really, you know, there's no hard data, and it's not, there's no Latin words in my book or anything like that. Trying to get those people interested in my book, I'm giving away free music to them. And then also, I don't want to alienate people in the literary world that have no idea or have never heard the name Freaky Flow. So I've kind of kept those streams separate, but there is some overlap there. So, giving away stuff free is always a huge help. I'm giving away the first four chapters written for free on antfarmbook.com. And then at my music site at freakyflow.com, I'm giving the first four chapters away as audiobook chapters. Because I figure my music fans are probably more likely to want an audio version of the book.
Did you voice it?
Yeah, I voiced it.
Well, there you go. It's you got all that work done yourself. What about, there's a lot of people are publish libertarian books, right? You know, there's Healing Our World. There's Harry Brown's body of work. Just a
countless.
You know, countless. It's happening all the time. What made you think that you were going to be of any success? Well, you know, why'd you have to put out Ant Farm? There's so many books out there.
You know, there are a lot of books out there. One of the ones you mentioned is really a personal favorite, and that's Mary Ruart's Healing Our World. But I feel like a lot of these books really preach to the converted, for lack of a better word. Maybe not Mary Ruart so much, but at least they're still preaching to people that are already interested in philosophy. My book is really trying to go after people that have never even thought about philosophy before and sort of lure them in. And I don't think there's any pro-liberty books or voluntarist books that really do that, unless I'm mistaken. And certainly, if there are, I think not a lot of them are fictional, and not a lot of them are really geared towards, you know, philosophical lay people that have no idea what, say, the non-aggression principle might be. My book doesn't even mention the non-aggression principle, but it incorporates the non-aggression principle through a narrative story and shows people why that's a good principle. You know, through the characters and their interactions, it shows that the characters that abide by the non-aggression principle tend to do well and live fruitful lives, and the people that are the ants, rather, that want to go ahead and violate that principle create all kinds of just horrible things in their world, and much in the same way that that's happening all over the world today, including in the U.S. and in Canada and many other places too.
I think it's interesting, you know, that you've got this career. You said a 20-year-long career in music. And have you been a DJ? I see on your Facebook page you're a drum and bass DJ. Have you been doing that the whole 20 years, or did you start in a band, or what was your history there?
I started as a hip-hop DJ. My first musical passion was hip-hop, and then I got into drum and bass just a couple of years later, and I started incorporating hip-hop into my drum and bass. And so, yeah, for almost all of those 20 years, I've been DJing drum and bass with a little bit of hip-hop sprinkled in. And also, you know, I like other genres of music too, so I'll blend those into my DJ sets as well.
Now, are you producing original music, or are you just DJing other people's music?
Over the years, I've gone through phases when there's time to produce my own music as well. I do have a series of new songs coming out later this year. A couple of them will be given away later in the year on freakyflow.com, and then a couple of them are coming out on a small label, a U.S. label called Symbolism Recordings. So I've got about six new tracks in the pipeline that I've been involved in producing.
Now, I'm not familiar with what drum and bass is, and I, you know, barely know hip hop, right? You know, I haven't listened to any of your music. I certainly read your book, and it's great, and I highly recommend it. As I especially just love the way that it kept flowing into each other. It's a short read, but it's really succinct. What can you explain what drum and bass is for people like me who just don't know this stuff? I mean, it sounds self-explanatory.
It may sound that way because, you know, two of the heaviest parts or the most important parts are the drums and the bass. But it's certainly, you know, you don't hear the words and know immediately what it sounds like, I think. Basically, it's a form of electronic music, but it's a really sort of niche and a little more obscure. It's not as big or as popular as house or trance or dubstep, but it's been around for a very long time. And, you know, if you think of your standard house music song in about the 120, 130 BPM range, beat per minute range, drum and bass is really fast. It's more in the 175, 180 beat per minute range. So it's really a high... Sorry, why?
I said, oh my.
Oh, okay.
I suppose why is because they somebody will buy it, would be my guess, is the reason why. Somebody wants to hear it.
Hey, Stephen, can you stick with us for another segment here? I've got some more questions for you.
Sure, of course. Right. Happy to.
Stephen Aaron Gray is with us, a.k.a. DJ Freaky Flow.
So 180 beats per minute, is that like the kind of thing that people do, like, you know, spin cycling to, or, you know, like aerobic? I really don't know.
Electronic music's great to listen to when you're doing, you know,
exercise, right? Like, you want to do something
sure.
You know.
Or driving or whatever. Hey, stand by. We're going to bring you back here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I know Derek J. and I have been to our share of rave parties, so we've definitely experienced
much more experience than
drum and bass. There's more coming up here in moments. This is Free Talk Live.
Are you living with pain? I was, after a nasty fall. I got relief with 1-Hour Pain Relief. I'm Barry Yarkoni, president, and here's Lisa, a Marine who was injured in Iraq.
After surviving an explosion, I was on horrible painkillers for lingering head, shoulder, back, and knee pain. But I hated the dangers and side effects. My friend told me about one-hour pain relief, and now I'm off the drugs.
One-hour pain relief is the result of 15 years of research on an amazing extract from hops, the plant used to flavor beer.
Whether your pain is from an injury or just aging, you get safe, all-day relief in less than 1 hour.
Get a free one-week trial for just the small shipping charge. Call 800-900-1221 right now or visit onehourpainrelief.com. There's no gimmicks, no obligation, no automatic shipments. Stop living with pain. Call 800-900-1221 or visit onehourpainrelief.com. That's 800-900-1221 or onehourpainrelief.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateurs, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want. Just dial toll-free 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We have author and drum and bass hip-hop DJ, DJ Freaky Flow, a.k.a. Stephen Aaron Gray, on the line with us here. We're going to continue with him here in a moment. Also, want to let you know how to get a free pound of coffee. Some of the best coffee out there from BuzzBox. It's shade-grown, 100% organic. and top 1% grade Arabica. All you have to do is go to coffee.freetalklive.com to get signed up. Get your first pound for free. You just pay the shipping cost. It comes to you. You'll hopefully love it. They think you will. And Mark, you're drinking like a pot of this stuff at least every single day. You're now brewing it here. You're drinking a pot at home and brewing some at the studio.
It's just a cup
as well.
Yeah.
What? Wait, what?
Just I'm just having an additional cup here.
Oh, here at the studio. Okay, gotcha. So it's great stuff, and a number of our listeners have signed up. In fact, for every 10 Free Talk Live listeners that sign up at coffee.freetalklive.com, we can finance another microloan via Kiva out to various people around the world who want to make a better life for themselves. And once those loans are paid off, we'll send them back out as new loans to new people who need some money. So you can help us help other people by going to coffee.freetalklive.com and at the same time get some awesome coffee while you're at it. In fact, it's delivered right to your home or office or wherever you want it delivered, and you can have it delivered in the frequency and the amount that you prefer. So go to coffee.freetalklive.com. You can cancel that subscription at any time. Again, that's coffee.freetalklive.com. Stephen Aaron Gray, a.k.a. DJ Freaky Flow, welcome back to Free Talk Live. Thanks for sticking with us for a little bit here.
Of course, my pleasure. Thank you.
Yeah, so you're a DJ. You've been doing this for 20 years, which is quite a career. You've built up a bit of a fan following, and that's helped you launch this book that we've been talking about on the air called Ant Farm, which you can go to, I believe it's antfarmbook.com to check out the first four chapters for free. And you said that your DJ business has sort of helped you promote this book out there. And I kind of wanted to talk to you about, you know, being a DJ and that aspect of things and the audience out there. Having been to a number of rave parties myself over the years, and Derek J, I think, as well, it's my impression, and I'm wondering if you agree with this, that the audience in the rave scene tends to lean to the left. Would that be true from your perspective?
I would say no, I would disagree.
Really?
I would say that they're completely apolitical for the most part. I think you're probably right in just the general sense of, you know, from issue to issue, maybe they think of themselves as very compassionate, or so they think, and so maybe they would align left on most issues or some issues. But I think for the most part, they don't even think about these issues. A lot of them are very music and art driven, and sometimes they don't think about the greater issues, you know, things that affect their lives and their families' lives. And, you know, so that's unfortunate to me. And I wanted to sort of use this book as an opportunity to serve as a wake up call for some of these people that don't necessarily think of these issues.
Yeah, I think that's very interesting. So what sort of response have you been getting from people? I mean, how easy or difficult is it to integrate promoting a book into appearing at a party where
it's got to be difficult.
Yeah, a lot of people are there.
Definitely.
They're there to have fun. They're there to party. You know, some of them are on drugs. You know, how do you do that? Because, I mean, it's one thing if you're like a musician and you're selling T-shirts. That's the obvious thing, or selling CDs. But you've got a book on your table, so to speak. What's that like?
That's right. Yeah, well, I did just have a DJ gig in Baltimore this past weekend on Saturday night. I started at 2 a.m., which is not uncommon.
Yep.
And before that, they had a sort of an in-house merch booth. And so I left some of my books there, and then I put up some posters around. And the posters essentially say on them, Freaky Flow wrote a new book. It's about philosophy, not music. And then there's a little message on there that says, free CD when you buy a book.
Ah,
so
cool.
Yeah, so really trying to entice these people to become interested in through offering them freebies, free music, which I think, you know, people love free stuff. They love free music. So that worked well. And then again, I've tried to make it so that the message of the book, even though at its core it's a very pro-liberty message, certainly on its surface, when you read the book, you're not going to immediately think, wow, this is a really political or a very philosophical book. It's a really sort of simple story that I think, even if you've had no history in politics or philosophy, you'll understand what's going on. You know, I really tackle all kinds of issues in this book, from healthcare to gun control to, you know, wages and unions and, you know, all kinds of things that you see in the news every day. And I'm sure these people that go to these events and people in the music world, they encounter these things and just don't always think about them as concretely as maybe you or I or some of your regular listeners do. Mm-hmm. And so You know, that's really been the idea, is to get people at these events, but also book people, you know, people that are interested in literature, to pick up this book and, you know, get the free chapters at antfarmbook.com.
Yeah, and I mean, then, it's not hard to get libertarians to pick up a book, which is why I was more interested in hearing, you know, what's the music scene like? How's that working? So I'm glad to hear you saying it's actually worked, that people are buying the book, if ostensibly to get the free CD. But if you're going to buy a book to get a free CD, hopefully you're going to read the damn book too, I would think.
Yeah, you know, I was concerned before I started writing this that if music people go and buy this book, it can't be something that's really too heavy, or I don't want a book with tons of statistics because they're going to throw it away immediately. I think that this still relates to their creative sensibilities enough that they'll want to continue reading.
Smart stuff. Any you guys have some questions?
A lot of times, you know, I mean, DJs tend to be regional. Are you regional in a particular area or
international?
Yeah, I don't really know much about this other than DJs tend to be regional.
You know, I guess some DJs tend to be regional. Through my career, I've played in about, I think, 10 different countries, and I used to do a lot more international travel about 10 years ago, but it really got to be draining. I was going to Europe probably two or three times a year, Asia about once a year. And so in the last 10 years or so, I've tried to limit my travel just within North America, just Canada and the U.S. So, yeah, I've enjoyed, you know, a good amount of success around the world, but you know, it's pretty draining to, you know, several times a year take off for 2-3 weeks to a different country. It's much easier for me to, you know, I live in Los Angeles now, so it's much easier to just fly out on a Friday and fly back home on a Saturday and not have to be on the road for so long.
Very cool. Stephen, Aaron Gray, appreciate you coming on Free Talk Live here tonight. And by the way, the book is available when you go to antfarmbook.com. You click through, you'll be able to get it through Amazon. And of course, if you want to, you can also go to shop.freetalklive.com, and you can go through the Amazon link there and then search for Ant Farm, a novel about what's bugging society. I love the subtitle there. And thanks for coming on the show tonight.
Guys, thank you. Appreciate it.
Appreciate that. All right. So our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Julian Assange still stuck in a Ecuadorian embassy in London.
That's right.
But yet he has come out in hologrammatic form. Derek J. has that story. And of course, we can talk to you about whatever happens to be on your mind. The toll-free number here tonight, 855-450-FREE. Plus, one spokesperson, Grover Norquist, is saying libertarianism is the future. Is he right about that? We can look into that claim here in just a few moments. Your calls are also welcome about whatever's on your mind. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. You take control here of Free Talk Live. Skype username, by the way, is lrn.fm. There's more coming up.
Are you ready to surrender your right to buy body armor? No joke. Congress is now trying to outlaw civilian body armor. And if House Bill H.R. 5344 becomes law, you can kiss your right to protect yourself against rifle bullets goodbye. Don't put off your body armor purchase any longer. Go now to infidelbodyarmor.com. Thousands of military veterans trust their lives to Infidel Body Armor. You should too. Spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
I couldn't believe it. Someone recently asked me if I had a facelift because I'm looking so much younger. I was stunned. How would that make you feel? It's because of my new anti-aging lotion that lifts, firms, and has dramatically reduced my crow's feet. You know you're ready to look younger. So call now and receive a GCN special offer. 1-844-500-0815. That's 1-844-500-0815. Or visit faceliftlotion.com.
If you're looking for work, it's a process of elimination, and you're trying not to be eliminated. So here's a tip for making the cut, and this might seem subtle, but to the person interviewing you, it's not. There is a world of difference between applicants who convey, "I need a job," and those who simply ooze, "I want to work, especially in these lean times when many you're competing with will seem desperate in I'll take anything mode. If you convey specific interest in this job at this company, you will be conspicuous. Thus, the value of going to school on the company you're applying to before the interview. With money and attention so tight now, effective communication skills have never been more important. For more tips for job seekers and everyone else, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live, the show where anyone can call about whatever they want. And we do mean anyone.
He bought a radiation monitor on eBay for $10.
You gotta be kidding me.
A Geiger counter?
Yeah. Okay. So I said, let's put some batteries in it and get it fired up. So we fired it up. We started walking.
You guys
around.
Know how to spend an evening.
Yeah,
get a
right?
couple of beers. Hang out with a Geiger counter.
We were making readings of 10 Rentgens outside the house.
What's that mean? Is that bad?
Yeah, it is.
Is that dangerous?
Yeah, it is.
Really? Rentgens. Now, where's the life-threatening one?
100 Rentgens. I'm really concerned now because I've seen...
But you weren't concerned before you got the radiation meter out.
Right.
Now you're definitely going to get cancer, Harry. What's the detector going to do for you, though? Really? I mean, if you're going to die, you're going to die, right?
The guy that just called in about radiation, first of all, you got a Geiger counter off the internet.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Talk Live, dial toll-free here, and bring up anything that you want. The number is 855-450-FREE. You can join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm, and Mark and I are gearing up for the weekend where we're going to be down in Orlando.
That's right, at the Coins in the Kingdom event. It's going on in Orlando at the Walt Disney World Resort, the Wyndham Lake Buena Vista in downtown Disney. Now, as I understand it, you don't have to get a ticket for Disney in order to go to this event. The tickets for this event are $60. Kids are free. If you want to get a hotel room,
I'm pretty sure $100. $60 is less than what it costs to go to Disney World.
I'm pretty sure it is, too. So I just don't want people led into the opinion that they're going to get a ticket to this event, and then somehow there's a ticket to Disney in the offing.
This $60 gets you into Coins in the Kingdom, which is basically a weekend-long event.
Yeah, it is. 2 days, and there's going to be lots of folks there who are into Bitcoins besides us. They're billing it as a Bitcoin party, but there's going to be speeches, and you learn about Bitcoin, lots of networking amongst people who are in the Bitcoin community, and I think that's what it's really about, is sort of the community. It's coinsinthekingdom.com. Come on in. Have a great time. Yes, they will be going to Disney on the Monday after the event. Mm-hmm. Everybody all at a great time and all together have a great time. Coinsinthekingdom.com.
I'm looking forward to it. I've enjoyed every Bitcoin event we've been to. It's sort of, we seem to be like the Bitcoin event radio show, like we're the go-to radio
true.
Show. And I'm happy with that. I think it's a nice little niche for Free Talk Live, and it's been fun.
I think Bitcoins are going to change the world, so I'm happy to be the... And I think Free Talk Live wants to see the world change for the better, and so I'm happy to be involved in whatever way I can.
I always have a good time at these Bitcoin events, and this one seems to be a little bit more oriented around fun, so I think it'll be even better than the last ones that we've attended. So looking forward to that. Coinsinthekingdom.com, go, and it's not too late to get your tickets online. as I understand it. We're going to get to the hologram Assange here in just a moment, but we've got Halty on the line in New Jersey, which is where Derek J. hails from originally. Halty, you're on Free Talk Live.
Oh, hey, guys. Listen, I feel like I'm calling from the past, calling into the future here, because I'm driving home listening to the podcast, and I was listening to last Friday's episode with Ellen, and I believe it was, I'm not sure who the other gentleman was.
Daryl and myself.
You guys are talking about, that's right, Daryl, thank you. And you guys are talking about thorium, and I called in about that a while ago. I just want to set the record straight that, you know, as you did find out in your research, that thorium is very abundant. But there's also a lot of extra stuff laying around. I mean, it's part of the mining process when you're trying to get rare earth metals. So it's not like this stuff is not available. I'm sorry for jumping right into this. I know you're totally off topic here. But
no, it was an interesting discussion we had on Friday night, just to catch everybody up with that, is, you know, the idea that thorium is this much safer nuclear reactant, if you will, that the really useful thing for about thorium that I picked up from this Forbes piece that we were sharing is that you can stop the reaction. Now, that's the issue with, like, the Fukushima meltdown, is that that reaction's still going on. Those those rods are still reacting, and that's a problem.
Yeah.
It's very dangerous as a result of that, and radiation, etc. With a thorium reaction, as I understood what we were sharing, is that as soon as you stop shooting these neutrons at the element, if you will, that it stops the reaction. Whereas with uranium-based reactions, you can't stop the reaction. It just keeps on going, and I don't know how you'd handle that. So it's a lot safer.
Yeah, generally you're right. I mean, I like to use the analogy of like a balloon. And, you know, a conventional nuclear reactor is a balloon that's constantly filling up, and you always have to let a little air out of it. Now, if you walk away from that balloon, it's going to pop. But with a liquid fluoride thorium reactor, a lifter, the balloon deflates slowly, and you have to make sure it keeps on filling up. So if you walk away from it, it's just going to deflate. It's not going to pop.
Right. And, so they can stop a reaction. So if something were to go wrong with a thorium-based nuclear reactor, they could just turn a switch, and it would be done.
Does that make it meltdown-proof?
Basically, yes.
Well,
and
hold on. I want to talk to the guy who knows what he's talking about.
Hey, Mark, listen, it's a great question. It's funny, because it's a liquid fluoride thorium reactor, it's already melted. So it's melted. That's the way it works. It's a melted salt. It's liquid salt.
Okay.
And the way that it kind of takes care of itself, if you walk away from it, is that if electricity disappears from the situation, this plug that's frozen salt gets so hot, it melts. And then all the melted salt just drains into a tank in the ground where it's not dangerous. It just sits there and waits for, you know, maintenance crew to come along and start it back up again.
The byproduct as well from this reaction is also a lot safer. The doesn't stay radioactive for near as long, like 500 years compared to 10,000 years, and there's a fraction of it. So, like, you know, the byproduct of a uranium-based reaction, that stuff, there's a lot of it in comparison to thorium. Like, thorium is, like, apparently 1,000 to 10,000 times less the remnants, if you will, the radioactive byproduct.
Right.
And so there's a lot less off product, and then, you know, that it doesn't stay as radioactive for as long. You can stop the reaction. Like, there's all kinds of reasons why thorium should be the basis for nuclear power, except the reason why, what was really most interesting about this article was why is it uranium? Well, guess what? It was weapons development is why it's uranium. They were, you know, the Manhattan Project, all this research and this money was being poured into atomic weaponry, and that's why uranium
was
useful.
That was my next question, is how dangerous is thorium if somebody wants to make some kind of dirty bomb or something?
That's right. Yeah, well, thorium itself is not fissile. It's fertile, which means it needs to take neutrons to become dangerous. And it only happens inside the reactor. So if you have this stuff outside of the reactor, it's in the concrete in the foundation of your building. It's in granite stone. It's in the granite state. It's all over the place. This stuff is very common. And, you know, it's not dangerous by itself, although it is technically considered a radioactive substance, and that's why the NRC regulates it. So, you know, if you read the there's a book called the Radioactive Boy Scout. It's about a kid who is using thorium. You know, he's getting it out of lanterns that were in, you know, old camping lanterns that they make this stuff out of. And anyway, long story short, he, he gets a bunch of this stuff and tries to make his own nuclear reactor, and the NRC tracks him down. And I mean, it's not exactly safe, but it's also not nowhere near as dangerous as uranium.
One of the real problems with the current electrical grid, besides pollution, and I want to talk to you about thorium and pollution here in a second, but one of the problems is the loss of energy through running electricity across the grid. The grid is this big, giant power supply thing that covers basically half the nation. I think that the Continental Divide it might be involved there somewhere, but it's huge. And they have to keep it all powered all the time, and these power plants, I mean, there's resistance in these lines. Many of them are old. How close can you? I mean, how small can a thorium reactor be? Can it power just a neighborhood?
Well, that's one really interesting thing about it, is because it doesn't use high pressure water like a conventional reactor. It doesn't need this thing called a containment dome, and the containment dome is simply a very large structure that's around the actual core of an existing reactor that prevents. In the event of a meltdown or an explosion, it contains all that radioactive steam that's in there. A liquid fluoride thorium reactor runs off of liquid melted salt. It's not under high pressure. It's under atmospheric pressure. So if a pipe leaks, it just dribbles out and solidifies. It doesn't go anywhere. It doesn't spray into the atmosphere and cause, fallout. And so that's one of the big selling features. It's also a very modular design. So these things can be built in a factory and then shipped to the site where they're supposed to be manufactured. So there's an advantage of economy of scale there.
Huge advantage of economy of scale there.
And it literally would, they may be smaller in terms of megawatt output, but if they can be put in municipalities, your municipality can have its own energy source.
I don't want to have power for my municipality. I don't trust those people.
How about my neighborhood?
Right. I'm talking about me getting together with between, 5 and 500 people that I, want to put together my own arrangement with. Is that possible?
Absolutely. Yeah.
What about what about pollution?
Yeah, the only pollution is it has a very limited amount of radioactive waste, very small compared to uranium reactors. And it's also not radioactive as long. But also, other waste can be used, again, for radioactive use in medical industry. So and also for space exploration.
Thanks for the call tonight, Halty. I appreciate it. There's more coming up here on Free Talk Live.
If Americans continue their reckless disregard of the U.S. Constitution, our freedoms and way of life may not continue. Original Intent, Spoiler, and Moulin Labbé is a 3-movie special that explains what we can do. From the director of Fiat Empire, this trio of movies features Ron Paul, Pat Buchanan, Edwin Vieira, and many others. On sale now at moviepubs.net. This is a mini library you don't want to be without.
Wake up and smell the freedom. One of the easiest things you can do to help Liberty is to torrent Freedom Fiends episodes to help keep them drone-proof. You can set up your home computer to download and share Freedom Fiends archives over BitTorrent. You can even set up scheduling so it only shares while you're asleep or at work. Put your unused computing power to work and help keep the Freedom Fiends around well into the future. Simply go to freedomfiends.com and click on the Torrent Club link and learn how to torrent and share Freedom Fiends archives.
Have you heard? Proactive Plus is faster and better than ever. Stay tuned for a million bottle giveaway, and you'll also receive free shipping. Do you have troubled skin? Acne? Well, we have great news. With Proactive Plus, your acne can heal, and you can help prevent new breakouts from happening. Don't miss this limited time offer. Give us a call at 800-538-5252, because we're going to let a million people try Proactive Plus risk-free and get 2 free gifts and also receive free shipping when you call right now. You heard it. This offer won't last long. So call Proactive Plus now, and you'll receive a 60-day risk-free trial of Proactive Plus, 2 free extras, and free shipping. Call 800-538-5252. This is our exclusive radio offer, never on TV. Get your risk-free 60-day trial of Proactive Plus with free shipping. That's right, free shipping. Don't wait. Call 800-538-5252. That's 800-538-5252.
Do you need access to money? Do you need cash today? If you are receiving a structured settlement due to a lawsuit, or you are receiving pension payments over a long period of time, the Money Settlement Hotline can get you instant funding now. With your cash today, you can pay off credit card debt, pay medical bills, fund your education, or improve your home. You don't need to wait. It's true. If you're receiving a structured settlement or pension payment spread out over time and you want a lump sum amount immediately, then you need to call now. They will turn your long-term structured settlement or pension payments into a lump sum larger cash payout, so you'll get all of your money instantly. If you have a structured settlement or pension and you want cash today, call the Money Settlement Hotline right now.
888-785-0616. 888-785-0616. 888-785-0616. That's 888-785-0616.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You dial toll-free, bring up anything you want. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Let's see. The Grover Norquist says libertarianism is the future. Is he right about that? Well, obviously, we'd like to think so, but I'd like to see what he has to say here in a moment. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Plus, Derek J. will be telling us about the hologrammatic version of Julian Assange, which hologram technology is getting pretty neat. So we can look into that here as well. Your calls and thoughts are certainly welcome. Once again, the toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Now, Julian Assange has been kept on his, you know, own volition. He had to go there and basically hide out in the Ecuadorian embassy in London. What's it been, 3 years now, Derek J? Do you know when it was that he wound up in there?
I don't have the facts on that, but it seems
it feels like
about
at least
3 years,
if not three.
Yeah, but now he's appearing. He snuck into the U.S. through his technology.
Now, that was sort of an announcement that came out ahead of that time. It's like Julian Assange will be leaving the Ecuadorian embassy or something like that came out. It was like a promo for what occurred.
Yeah, I was following because I find this guy just so fascinating with his history of WikiLeaks and sharing information and changing the world through bringing information to people.
Looks like it was August of 2012. So a solid 2 years now.
Wow.
He's been in that Ecuadorian embassy.
Yeah, well, I really like him because he's just an expert on getting past, you know, or going over the heads of authorities and just saying, you know, I'm going to bring this to the people whether you like it or not, you know, and he's proven that by hologramming into a U.S. conference, you know, though his body may not be able to make it, the information about his body position.
Did we mention what he's known for? I don't know if we did that.
No. Julian Assange is known as the creator of the website WikiLeaks.
Which he's a wanted man.
Yes. It's a website which has, I don't know, hundreds of thousands of declassified cables, or I don't know if even some of them
lots
are
of info.
Still classified.
Lots
yeah.
of info that the governments of the world, specifically the U.S. and the United Kingdom, these governments do not want you to know about, and he has sort of ruined the party for a lot of the government guys around the world, and so that's why they're pretty upset at him.
Yeah, it's also the website where Chelsea Manning uploaded her videos
about
the war crimes that were happening in Iraq, and that upset a lot of bureaucrats as well.
And Chelsea Manning, unfortunately, is in prison for a long time.
Yes. So here's the article from Russia Today that says Julian Assange has transcended the confinement of his Ecuadorian embassy asylum to attend the 2014 Nantucket Project. as a hologram. In his ghostly entirety, Assange was speaking about censorship, control, and manipulation of history, which I just think is so, it's so beautiful to have an action like this. Like, he's talking about censorship beyond the gated walls, you know? Like, here
well,
he is.
He's stuck, right?
Well, not really. Not, I mean, yes, he's stuck. His
stuck
body
and
is
not
stuck.
Stuck. I find him, for one, I think he's a superlative speaker on the issues that he, you know, confronts. But yeah. I think it's, you know, he can speak more powerfully than most. He's stuck in the embassy, but he's using technology to transcend that.
Yes. And speaking with filmmaker Eugene Jarecki, Assange closed the 2014 event, sharing his thoughts on importance of research and free access to information and the risks of censorship. He said, quote, "As a researcher, I'm all too well aware of what people are now calling Google blindness, that the information you can't find on the internet doesn't exist."
Mm.
And he didn't miss a chance to take on the corporation, Google, and called it a revolving door of NSA and close partner, a close partner of the U.S. government. And he's right, but... I'm seeing a lot of good development from Google as well. The FBI is slamming them for having too good encryption.
I have that story, and that's one of those things that we haven't had a chance to really talk about here on Free Talk Live. And just kind of insert, we can get back into Assange here in a moment, but I actually had that pulled up for the show prep tonight. There, so the news was that Apple, with their new iOS version, they have implemented an encryption scheme that even Apple will not be able to break. Or so the claim is, right? That's the claim, is that now the user can encrypt their own data. In fact, it'll be encrypted by default, apparently, with the new Apple system. And then Google came out with basically a Me Too announcement. Oh, yeah, we've got that. And in fact, Google's...
Now, I've heard that, like, this sort of battle between the two giants here, and I tend not to believe either, that, you know, Apple's more user-friendly when it comes to sharing the information to the government, more individual-friendly. No, Google is. I've heard both sides of this.
I don't believe
them. How could you know?
Yeah, that's just the thing. Like, I know that the FBI here is acting like they're all upset. The headline is from the Washington Post. James B. Comey, the FBI director, has criticized Apple and Google on Thursday for developing forms of smartphone encryption so secure that law enforcement officials cannot easily gain access to information.
Trapped! We've been foiled again!
Stored on the devices, even when they have valid search warrants. So the idea being
all these giant corporations that are bought and paid for by U.S. government tax dollars, they've gotten us!
Yeah, that's just it. Like, I don't know if I believe anybody, right? I don't know if I believe that Apple and Google's new encryption scheme is really ironclad, or that it doesn't have some way for the government to get access, or if the government's being honest, or this is like all some sort of show to make people think that there's actually real encryption going on here when in fact there's still a back door. I don't know.
I buy it. Here's why. Google and Apple are still companies that have to depend on their customers buying things.
That's
and
true.
And they are competitors, meaning, and they don't have a monopoly over encryption. Like, right, encryption, anyone could use it. So any company that comes along and offers better encryption to their customers, they're probably going to win out.
Right.
So
and
Apple and Google need to embrace this.
If we find out that what they've told us about the NSA up to this point is a lie, which we found out everything about the NSA up to this point is a lie, and we refuse to do business with them in the future, they'll throw us in jail for not paying our income tax. Whereas if we find out that what Apple and Google have said at this point is a lie, then some people will attempt to stop using them. Mm-hmm. I will feel entirely differently about Apple and Google, more so Google. You know, like I'm on a team, right? I like the Google team better than the Apple team. I'll admit it. But I'm going to feel entirely different about Google than
if it turns out they were lying about this.
If it turns out
encryption,
they're lying about it. Like right now, I'm a Google stockholder, and I'm going to really not like this company much.
I don't know.
No, I get it. I want to believe them, but at the same time, I still don't trust Apple or Google with data encryption.
Good, use your own encryption.
Well, that's the other thing. What the hell do you trust? Because now, you know, TrueCrypt, which was this independent program that had existed for years, they came out last or earlier this year with a press release saying, "Well, TrueCrypt's not secure. We're abandoning the project." And so that was really bizarre. And then when the TrueCrypt guys came out with that notice, they said, we think you should use Microsoft's encryption scheme. Like, what? Why would the people who are behind TrueCrypt, this open source encryption project, recommend Microsoft for encryption on their way out the door? It was just so suspect and so bizarre. Who do you trust out there? If you're not a programmer, you can't audit this code. Now, rumor, from what I've heard, I can't check this claim, but from what I've heard, there's a group of people out there who are auditing TrueCrypt's final code release to see if it was indeed secure. I don't know how far along they are on that audit. I don't know if that's been completed yet or not, but still, I would trust something like TrueCrypt more than I would trust Apple or Google.
Did TrueCrypt have any sort of warrant canary or a way to tip off their customers that they've been contacted by the authorities?
I don't know.
Okay, yeah. Well,
Maybe one of our geek listeners will be able to inform us on that.
Oh, I wonder if something like that could become more common as we see the federal government is sticking its nose in places people might not expect. Might it become more common to visit freetalklive.com and see a message that says, we have not been contacted by the authorities, just to be aware of those sorts of things when the message sort of changes, right?
So I like the idea of what Apple and Google have done here, and I like that the FBI appears to be upset by it. It's just hard for me to really trust mega corporations.
Well, they've got the FBI is not upset because they've got an arsenal of weapons that they can use to unlock phones. It's not like one little bit of encryption is really going to stop them.
If Google and Apple have encrypted their phones, yes, the FBI is upset because they like you to be wide open to them.
Well, they want it to be easier to crack your phone open, but it's not impossible. I mean, I'm sure they've got another way.
If a burglar that has robbed your house every month for a year finds out you've put in a new security system, is he going to be upset? Mm-hmm. I think upset's a proper term for that burglar.
Well, let's go back to why Julian Assange thinks Google is evil.
I definitely want to hear that.
In the digital world, Assange says people could just delete history very easily, a notion he attributes to Orwell's writing, "He who controls the present controls the past. He who controls the past controls the future."
There's more about Assange coming up. The hologram version of Assange, and you can take control of the airwaves here. 855-453 is the toll-free number, 855-450-3733. Your thoughts on the mega corporations protecting your privacy as well. That's welcome. Anything goes. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com.
I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Monday, September 29th, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,220. Silver opened at $17.51. And Bitcoin is trading around $373.13. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by Express Coin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. Vote Michael Cargill to get the cars moving. Learn more or sign up to volunteer at CargillForTexas.com. Political advertisement paid for by the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. In the news today, civilians were killed while militants were wounded following Sunday night airstrikes in northern and eastern Syria. That word from the Britain-based Syrian Observatory for Human Rights, which is monitoring the war. According to the observatory, the airstrikes hit grain silos, mills, and other such targets instead of an Islamic State operations base. Reuters reports there has been no word from the Obama administration regarding the claims. On Saturday, hundreds of pro-Palestine protesters blocked an Israeli cargo ship from unloading at the Port of Oakland. Protesters wanted to express their anger with Israel's bombing of Palestinians in Gaza. The Stop Zim Action Committee organized the action against the Zim Shanghai ship. The protest marks the second time Israeli cargo ships were blocked after similar actions in California and Florida last month. Tomorrow, the activist group Fluoride Free Houston will be returning to the Houston City Council in a relaunched effort to end the practice of water fluoridation. The group first began lobbying the city in the summer of 2012, receiving support from two council members. Mayor Anise Parker, known for her environmental efforts, has yet to support the group. With the new campaign, the group hopes to educate Houston City Council members about the arguments against water fluoridation. Fluoride Free Houston member Derek Rose spoke about the group's mission.
Fluoride Free Houston aims to bring an end to water fluoridation in the city by raising awareness of city council members and citizens on the fact that it is a financial waste, a health hazard, an environmental hazard, it's a violation of civil liberties, and it affects Houston's poorest communities.
The group will attend the city council tomorrow and again on Tuesday, October 7th. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Cabo Bob's, Southwestern-style burritos, now with two locations in Austin, 500 East Benoit Boulevard and 2828 Rio Grande Boulevard. Find them online, CaboBobs.com. And support comes from Sovereign Living, a podcast, blog, and reality show about what it takes to live a voluntary and natural life. Check out the blog at SovereignLiving.com and watch episode 1 of the soon-to-be-released reality show at SovereignLiving.tv. This is the Liberty Beat for Monday, September 29th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. Texans for Accountable Government will be hosting a city council candidate forum and meet and greet this evening. The highly contested city council election is the first since the public voted for single-member districts in Austin. It's also the first council election to take place in November. There are several Liberty candidates on the ballot challenging non-Liberty incumbents. This evening, from 6 until 9 o'clock, the public will have the opportunity to meet the candidates and ask the tough questions. The event will be held at Sherlock's Baker Street Pub on Research Boulevard from 6 to 9. More information at tagtexas.org. On October 9th, the U.S. Commodity Futures Trading Commission will hold a public meeting on Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies. The commission will host a panel which will examine Bitcoin and the possible creation of a derivatives market for the popular cryptocurrency. The CFTC is an independent federal agency that regulates futures and options markets. 13 schools from the Houston Independent School District are now offering children the opportunity to participate in yoga programs as an alternative exercise course. The classes are part of a grant from the nonprofit Sunima Foundation, which reportedly donated at least $360,000 to HISD. The 45-minute classes include breathing exercises, yoga poses, and lessons in mindfulness. The schools are part of a study being performed by the University of San Diego's Center for Education Policy and Law. Today's edition of the Liberty Beat is brought to you by Brave New Books, your source for One World Way, Tangy Tangerine, and Clearly Filtered Fluoride Filters. Located in Austin, Texas at 1904 Guadalupe Street, or online at bravenewbookstore.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Monday, September 29th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Following reports of a newly posted job listing at area marketing firm Swenson Digital, The Onion spoke to a few of the 1,400 applicants who claim they are, quote, absolutely perfect for this position.
When I first saw this opening, I knew it was right for me. I've got tons of experience. I've got all the skills they're looking for.
If you look at my resume, I've got everything they're looking for. I mean, I've held similar jobs like this in the past. I'm extremely driven. I really think this is going to work out.
I've got a BA in marketing, which the posting said was recommended, so I think that'll bode really well for me. I've had plenty of team experience, and I think that would stand out. Not to mention the fact that I'm great with
web design and HTML, and pretty proficient with Excel and PowerPoint. Also, I think the culture is
very me, you know? I think I'd fit in well with the other employees. I also think I had a great resume
and cover letter. I think as soon as they interview me, they'll see I'm the perfect candidate.
As of this video's release, Swenson Digital had extended a job offer to an applicant who happens to be a friend of the boss's son.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Take control, toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features you'll find on our website and Derek J's website, derekj.me.
Yeah, go to that website. You'll see all sorts of videos and blog posts about freedom and liberty. It's the best. I just rehashed it, too. I just revamped everything.
Really?
So, yeah, it's a completely new site.
Wow.
So if you've been there before, go there again.
I'm totally going
to
go right now.
It's much easier to navigate. You know, all the shows that I do, Free Talk Live, mm-hmm. if you want to see Free Talk Live shows, easy to click on that.
Yeah.
Easy to find Victimless Crime Spree, a movie I produced in 2012 about moving to Keene, New Hampshire for more freedom. All sorts of goodies over at derekj.me.
You got another interview coming out soon, I imagine, with Jeff Berwick, the Anarchast. You did an interview there.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun. I'll be posting that there as well.
I'm excited to see that.
Yeah, it was a moment for me. I've always looked up to Jeff Berwick, the Dollar Vigilante. And I was really excited to be on his show.
Cool. So check him out, Derek J, over at derekj.me. Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. We're talking about Julian Assange, the hologram version of Julian Assange, who apparently appeared via hologram to, what was it, some sort of conference in the U.S.?
Yeah, it was called the 2014 Nantucket Project, which I've never heard of.
Me neither.
It sounds like a tech thing, maybe. He was talking about why he doesn't like Google, says it's a sort of a revolving door with the federal government and that they hand over requests for information too easily. And he's concerned about that because he says, as George Orwell put it, he who controls the present controls the past. He who controls the past controls the future. And so he's sort of calling Google like this controller of information, because if it's not online, it doesn't exist.
Well, you may remember the story from, I think it was earlier this year, if not late last year, where the European Central Court or whatever, the International Court, they, you know, came up with some ruling that essentially made it so Google would have to pull information on request.
Yes.
So if
only in certain places too.
In Europe, basically, as I understood the ruling.
No, not all of Europe.
No.
Because there are some countries, for example, Norway, I believe, which is, holds information to be like sacrosanct, and you know they will not delete it. They'll protect all information that's stored in Norway's servers, even if it's slanderous lies and, you know, like criminal. They'll keep it.
Well, that was the idea, was that if you saw something on Google that you didn't like, that you could contact them through some form now and have them remove search results. So it wouldn't delete it from the internet. If you knew how to get to it, you could still get to it. But deleting something from Google is almost like deleting it from the internet, simply because so many people use Google as their search engine of choice. And when that news came out, that was one of the saddest moments for me. As somebody who, like Mark, is I like most of what Google does. I think they bring a lot of useful services to mankind, and you know it's obvious that that's true because they're used by a lot of people.
But they're dangerously unprincipled. I mean, yeah. like I.
Well, their principles supposedly do no evil, right? Isn't that what their motto is? But clearly, they don't really know what that means.
Yeah, I.
Evil's hard to define.
Yeah. So that when that happened, I just thought, boy, that's not cool. Because I thought the right thing for them to do. I think it was actually France was where the decision originated.
Hmm.
And please, if you're in Europe and you can correct me on this, let us know at 855-450-FREE. But when that happened, I thought, oh, well, what Google really ought to do is just close all their offices in those countries where this is happening and say, oh, well, you don't want us to be here? Okay, see you later. We can still offer you Google from another country. You know, we can still have our website accessible by these countries, but if we close our offices there, then we can't be regulated by you. But no, they went ahead and accepted the regulation. And they came up with some form that you can submit and have stuff pulled from their search results. It was a huge disappointment
for me. Okay, but I gotta just, to be at the defense of Google here, they're like this huge rolling ball that's got all this momentum, right? And they're moving on their path. To have like minor obstructions like, oh, you can't do this, can't do that, they're ready for those sorts of obstructions, you know? They'll tackle those problems. They're not just going to say, all right, let's pack up and leave.
Oh, that's yeah, like they're just tackling government problems here and there.
That would be how they would tackle that problem. I mean, because by being able to use government force to force Google to remove search results because you don't like what some of the results are, that is, to me, a strike at what their business model was all about. Google was all about revealing information on the internet, helping connect their users with information, and this essentially short-circuits that. So,
I don't know.
Like Amazon, for instance, they will close a warehouse and close their offices in states where they're proposed to have sales tax put on their product, or you know, more regulations. The more regulated more regulations that are proposed in any given location means that Amazon's likely to just say, see ya, we'll go over here where we're wanted. And I was disappointed Google didn't do that, because they could have.
I'm speculating, but I think the difference might be, imagine you're an engineer at Google and you're tasked with the problem of, oh, here's a new technical problem to solve. We've got these websites, they can't be shown to these certain people. Mm-hmm. Figure it out. Or your alternative is to just leave, just pack it up. I mean, as a tech person who works for Google, you want to be a go-getter and get around this problem. So I just imagine they're trying to comply, though.
I mean, executives made that decision.
It's not engineers who are like, oh yeah, let's go comply with the government.
Yeah, and it's the engineers who have to implement it. Now, I'm sure against their better judgment, I'm sure the engineers would prefer to have open access to information at Google. But at the same time, you know, I don't blame Google for implementing the Chinese restrictions too. Like if you use Google in China.
I don't like that very much.
I don't like it, but I also don't blame them, because I guess China could probably ban Google or something like that. So it's a tough. I'm not saying it was an easy choice for them to make. It was just a bummer.
When you get big enough, you have to play politics, and I really don't like politics.
Yeah. Anyway, go on with the story from Assange.
Yeah, so he says, quote, the last 5 years have been the greatest period of education that ever existed. And Assange's hologram added in front of the audience, gathered in a tent overlooking Nantucket Harbor, Massachusetts, quote, the greatest number of people to the greatest geographic extent are learning about their environment and the complexities of the international environment. Yeah, he's right.
Yep.
Quote, my conclusion is that the best way to go about changing things is simply to act. At its essence, when civilization is working well, it commits us to not do dumb things again. To do that, we have to have the ability to learn from each other, to learn from the past, how our institutions actually behave, their internal dialogue. Ideas can only be as good as their inputs.
You know, I totally agree with what he's saying there, and I think that's what we're seeing happen here in New Hampshire with the Free State Project. And of course, for those that are new to the show, the Free State Project is the reason why we're here. It's the idea of moving liberty-oriented people all to the same geographic area to take action. The libertarian movement, you know, we talked earlier about all the books in the libertarian movement, and there's so many books. You can spend all your life reading libertarian-oriented
books. I bet you could come darn close.
Fiction, nonfiction, they're all out there. Academic, easy to read, it's all there. And that's what libertarians and liberty-minded people have been doing for decades, is they've been reading books and running political campaigns. And that's
writing
about
books.
And I'm not saying there's anything wrong with reading and writing books. That's great.
These are great ways to spread ideas.
But it's not as much action as I would like to see. And we're seeing the action part of libertarianism, taking those great ideas from the books and applying them in real life. We're seeing that happen to the greatest extent here in New Hampshire, and it's having an impact. So that action really does do things, and it really does help bring people on to the ideas of freedom, because, you know, your movie Victimless Crime Spree, Derek J, has influenced people to make the move here to New Hampshire. They've seen that, and they saw the action, and they were excited by that action. And also, he's talking about showing how the institutions work.
Mm-hmm.
No one's better at doing that than the people in Keene, New Hampshire, than the activists like you, Derek, who, you know, you're video blogging on a nearly daily basis, live to Derek J's, your Derek J live channel,
yes,
on YouTube. We've got, of course, you know, various different videos that have gone up. I've got a court video that's encoding right now that's going to go up with my trial from a couple weeks ago. And so we show people what these bureaucrats do. We show them, show people the damage that the state can do to peaceful people's lives. And of course, Cop Block's doing a great job of that on a nationwide basis as well. But I think that's so important, to take action, but not, don't take action in a vacuum. You've got to have a camera there. You've got to show people. You've got to document your action, so the people who are just watching and waiting and curious to know what's happening can know and hopefully be inspired by you to take action of their own. And one action I recommend is to join the Free State Project at freestateproject.org. There's more coming up.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Hey guys, if you're into fantasy football, you've got to check out FanDuel.com. At FanDuel, you play in one-week fantasy football leagues for real money with immediate cash payouts. You only play when you want, and you can change your team any week. FanDuel is paying out over $10 million every week this season. And right now, FanDuel is giving you up to $200 free. That's right, for every dollar you deposit, FanDuel will match it up to $200. Just go to FanDuel.com, click the microphone in the upper right corner, and enter code FOOTBALL70. FANDUEL.com, code FOOTBALL, the number 70.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges. Yeah!
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, take control here toll free. Bring up what you want. The number's 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about freedom on the internet, freedom in your real life, or whatever's on your mind goes. Here you just dial in or join us on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. We're talking about the hologram version of Julian Assange, who appeared sitting on a stool next to a real person sitting on a stool on a stage at the Nantucket something or other, some kind of tech expo in the United States. So much to the chagrin of U.S. authorities and other government goons around the world, they were unable to arrest the hologrammatic version of Julian Assange. It would be pretty amusing to try to fake out the government guys with a hologram and like make them think Julian Assange really is somewhere and have like the SWAT team run in and try to arrest him and put handcuffs on a hologram.
Now, the hologram didn't look like Julian Assange was really there, right? I mean, it was...
It looked pretty close.
Holograms look good on video. I don't know how they actually look in real life.
It's better than Princess Leia in Star Wars.
It's better. Same idea, though.
I was even looking during the video to see, can you see through his hand? Like, when he lifts up his hand, can you see through his hand to his shirt? And you can a little bit, so you can tell that it's a hologram if you're looking carefully. But I would imagine,
is there any kind of special... What kind of special equipment do they use?
I was actually looking for that during the break there. If somebody knows what the equipment is that is making this possible, because Assange's hologram isn't the first hologram. If you look up the Tupac hologram, because as you know, Tupac was allegedly murdered in the 1990s, but it was like last year, I think, when he made an appearance on stage during someone's concert. Tupac comes out and sings a song,
Wow.
Like they had, and it looked like Tupac on stage. So what it looks like in real life, I don't know. Does it appear to have depth, or is it like a flat looking thing when you're sitting in an audience? Because obviously, if you're looking at a video, you're not
seeing... It's always going to look flat.
Right. Unless you're looking at 3D video, which most people aren't, you're seeing a flat image, so you wouldn't really be able to perceive any depth in it. But it looks persuasive from the snapshots and the videos that I've seen of these things. They look very persuasive. And if this is like generation one of hologram technology, then generation 2, 3, 4, and 5 is going to be progressively more amazing and more lifelike and realistic and convincing and likely more affordable, to where this guy's life size. It's not like
you're saying. It's going to be more affordable.
Princess Leia in Star Wars, she was tiny in those scenes, right? Yeah. She was like a little hologram, and this is a life size hologram. So, I mean, we're already past that point, which is incredible.
That is amazing.
But what's the usefulness of it besides, like, I'm thinking WebEx, the Citrix go-to meeting or whatever, these companies that do these meetings. I mean, think that would be useful to have people sort of hologrammed in, maybe perhaps even to a virtual room where they can have a virtual meeting. You can already sort of do that with these programs that I've just mentioned and probably a myriad of others. Google Hangouts.
That kind of thing.
You can kind of do it already, just sort of sitting there.
We have things like, or there's already been things like Second Life, where you have sort of this virtual room with a character that represents you. So basically, you would be taking the virtual rooms that already exist, combining the new hologram technology with those virtual rooms. I mean, we're not far away from this at all.
I kind of feel like you get a better experience with having one of these virtual meetings. And I think the experiences are very important when you're trying to have meetings, because a lot of times it has sales involved. So, body language and facial expressions, these things are extraordinarily important. I'm just trying to figure out anything else that it might be useful for.
Yeah, well, I was speculating that porn may be leading the charge.
Porn has to be in there somewhere.
It won't be successful if porn doesn't pick this up. I mean,
well, the internet, to some extent, is about porn.
Well, right, we were talking about a VHS versus beta the other night on the show as well, when we were discussing thorium and uranium somehow led into a VHS versus beta discussion, and Daryl pointed out, and I think it's correct, that the porn industry chose VHS, and that was a huge bump for the VHS world.
Wow.
Yeah.
I had no idea.
Yep.
Yeah, I also speculate that these holograms, you know, I would want many of them throughout my house. Like, instead of buying art, I could buy hologram images and just change them every day or week or hour. You know, you could have art that changes on your wall.
We already have picture frames that'll show different photos, right?
Yeah, but this is even cooler.
Sure. Oh, it's very, it looks very cool.
So, Jarecki, the filmmaker that Assange was speaking with, he compared the WikiLeaks founder's ghostly appearance to the Star Wars that we're talking about here. He says, quote, "In a wink at life imitating art, it's the same old story of rebels against an empire. But in this case, Assange and kindred spirits such as Edward Snowden, Chelsea Manning, and Aaron Schwartz see themselves as a real-life band of rebels, loosely arrayed against an unholy global alliance of government and economic interests." Wow.
I'd say that's accurate.
Yeah, the Nantucket Project. Oh, here's our answer. It's an annual conference held over the past 3 years. Strives to provide a relaxed setting to gathered innovators, entrepreneurs, thinkers, and, quote, decision makers.
All right.
So, I guess executive people. So,
cool.
Yeah, I think it's great. I want to see more of these holograms. I'm excited that Julian Assange has snuck out of his embassy. I want to see him appear all over the place.
He claims in another article I was pulled up here because I was looking, I was trying to find info on the hologram tech, but I found another article about Julian's appearance. The claim is he's planning on leaving the Ecuadorian embassy at some point. I'm not sure how that's going to transpire, but he seems to believe that it will happen.
Huh.
And that'll be interesting to find out. Also, another addendum to our discussion about TrueCrypt. We were talking about these big companies, Google, Apple, you know, do you really trust them with your security? They're claiming their new operating systems on their phones are encrypted by default now, meaning that it's supposedly going to be a lot more difficult for the law enforcement to get access to your phone, because what they used to be able to do is just go to Google and Apple and get in through the, you know, the back door. But now their claim is that not even Google and Apple can crack the encryption, because it's, you know, it's up to you to, I don't know, it's encrypted by default, and somehow they've set it up to where they can't get into it. So do you really believe them? I don't know. We'll get your answers. I asked that question on Facebook. But Michael Dean from the Freedom Fiends sent a point about TrueCrypt, because I said, well, TrueCrypt, they bailed on their project. TrueCrypt was this independent open source project to create encryption that was, you know, really secure. And then all of a sudden, earlier this year or late last year, the TrueCrypt guys abandoned their project and said, we think you should use Microsoft instead of our project, and our project is not secure. And he says a lot of security people think that when TrueCrypt told people that, that was their warrant canary. That they,
what's a warrant canary?
The warrant canary is what Derek
it's a
was
warning.
Talking about earlier.
Yeah, it's a warning that some websites or businesses will put up in a public place to let their customers or public know that they have not been contacted by the government. And so if that ever disappears, well, you can figure out they have been contacted.
Right, because the government contact would say, you can't tell anyone you've been contacted. So at that point, they would remove the message saying they had not been contacted. Therefore, they're not telling anyone they haven't been that they've been contacted. But by default, you know that they've been contacted.
But,
so,
I mean, shouldn't I, as a user, just assume that the statement that they make is true, that they're that they've been compromised?
Well, that's what he's saying here, is that the reason the TrueCrypt team has been acting so, that they acted so strange at the end of, you know, bailing out of their own program and saying to use Microsoft instead, suggests that maybe they were contacted by the government and this was their only way of really communicating that. Mm-hmm. Obviously, it's speculation, but I think it's pretty interesting and could be true. Toll-free number tonight, because they're saying that the security experts are saying they think that the last version of TrueCrypt is secure, and then that, again, is why it's being audited to see if it is indeed. More coming up, 855-450-FREE.
At 30dayfoodsupply.com, you can now purchase a one-of-a-kind product not available anywhere else, a meatless burger dry mix in four delicious flavors. With our new Oregon Trail Foods vegan burgers, all you do is add water and fry. They need no refrigeration. They're packaged in Mylar bags with an oxygen absorber for a long shelf life. They're non-GMO. They're gluten, soy, nut, and chemical-free, but they're loaded with flavor and a good source of carbs and protein, yet low in sodium. Flavors include Italian, spicy Mexican, six vegetable, and black bean olive. Go to 30dayfoodsupply.com or call 541-229-0010 and order today. Eat them every day, take them camping, or save them for an emergency. Check them out at 30dayfoodsupply.com and click on the vegan burger icon. That's 30dayfoodsupply.com, where all of our products are produced in Oregon by Oregon Trail Foods. 30dayfoodsupply.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you want. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that are waiting for you there. We've got all kinds of great folks who are behind the show, including BitcoinBountyHunter.com. Bounties are available right now, and one of them is worth 38 Bitcoins at this moment. Now, 38 Bitcoins, that's a close to $400 per Bitcoin. You do the math. That's a lot of money for a bounty. But it could be more than that, because you can go to BitcoinBountyHunter.com and you can see the bounties that already exist. You can add your own. You can create your own bounty, or you can add Bitcoins to, or fractions of Bitcoins, to the existing bounty. So let's say let's say you go there and you see that one of those projects looks really neat. You want to catch that crook or that criminal or whatever, and you throw something into the pot. You can do that there. Look, the authorities aren't going to be solving these cases. It's going to be done by people like you, people who can profit from your work and skill. So go check out BitcoinBountyHunter.com. Again, that's BitcoinBountyHunter.com as we continue.
Be a bounty hunter.
So we were talking about the warrant canary, and I had asked the question, well, has anybody really done this? I mean, the idea has been put out there. We've discussed it before on this program. The Freedom Fiends with Michael W. Dean, they've got their own warrant canary. You're one of the regular hosts on Freedom Fiends, Derek J.
Yes. It's
one of your many radio responsibilities that you have taken on for yourself. Yep. And one of the sort of the show memes, if you will, is that you constantly say worms, usually when you're going to break or coming back in from a break. It's just
it's a substitute for hello, goodbye, this is cool. It's like aloha.
Worms.
It's like
worms.
Word used to be.
Yeah, sort of like that. And so the warrant canary for Freedom Fiends is if y'all stop saying worms, that means that, because it would be a huge noticeable thing if Freedom Fiends stopped saying worms. So that would mean that someone on the Fiends or the Fiends in some way had been contacted and threatened with one of these national security letters, threatened by the FBI or the CIA or whoever, with some sort of some threat that says, you will not reveal that you have been threatened. You know, you can't tell anyone about this national security letter or we're going to hurt you even more. That kind of thing.
Okay, and I won't. I'll just do everything radically different from now on. And everyone will notice.
So I thought that was an interesting way to go about things. But my question was, has someone with a warrant canary actually had to utilize their warrant canary? Have they done something like that? Have they pulled the statement from their website? Have they gone through this? And you found an example.
Well, yeah, I was suspecting that LavaBit, which was an old encrypted email service founded by Ladar Levison, I suspected that they had used a warrant canary. I seem to remember one back when they were pulled down after being contacted by the feds about like Edward Snowden's emails and stuff. But I didn't find that. Instead, what I found was news that Apple's warrant canary has recently disappeared.
Recently?
I just checked the date, September 18th of this year. So just a couple of weeks ago, here this reading from the link I found was on Reddit, the technology Reddit. And it's reading from GigaOhm.com. Jeff John Roberts writes that in his summary, Apple included language in its first transparency report to say that it had not been contacted subject to a Section 215 Patriot Act request. And that language is now gone. Pretty big deal. So it's explained in the article at GigaOhm.com, but just to condense a lot of data, Cory Doctorow, this guy who's a cyber activist and writer, he blogs about militarization of police and warrantless spying. He was actually the one who recognized that the language had disappeared. And this was part of their privacy agreement. It doesn't say for sure that they were contacted. Maybe they just changed their language. Who knows? But it makes me suspect.
Certainly sounds that way. And if you know of any examples you can share with us, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Now, what happens when you get one of these letters? What if you accidentally leave the letter out and somebody else picks it up? You know, if the letter comes to Free Talk Live, care of Mark or Ian, and it says, you at Free Talk Live will not reveal that you have received this letter or else you will be charged with all kinds of terrible things and locked up forever.
I've just got to say right now, God bless America.
What are you getting at, Mark? Does that mean you've had a letter or something?
Obviously, we are being protected by these people, and you know they wouldn't send out things like this unless it was absolutely necessary. Surely the government wouldn't compromise the Bill of Rights over just some kind of convenience for themselves or anything like that. This must be a real issue.
Now, this really happens, though. I mean, there are people who've been sent these national security letters, one of the classic
and
examples.
And they all deserve it.
One of the classic examples was a librarian, I think at some point came out about it. I forget the details of that
case. If we found out that information, clearly she's a seditious commie.
I don't think that's a very good Warrant Canary mark, because if that's what you're suggesting is that you would change your whole perspective on the show, that would be kind of annoying to have to deal with a sort of a commie mark on a nightly basis. But I was thinking, what if we changed your name back to Manwich? When we first started the show in...
Oh, that's great. Get ConAgra Foods to sue us.
2002.
That's our Warrant Canary.
Your
we
name
got a
was
business.
Man. Your name was Manwich on the show on a nightly basis. You weren't Mark. And then it wasn't until 04 or 05 or something like that when we got syndicated.
I think it was 05.
Yeah. And so after a while, after
maybe
we got syndicated, the network that we're on, we've never had – Genesis Communications Network is a great network, and I'm so grateful that we've been working with them over all these years, because basically they've left us alone. They've never said, you need to change this about your show, and you can't talk about this. And they've never had any programmatic input onto the show at all. And I appreciate that about them. But the one thing that ever happened was in the early, early days, they got a little nervous about Mark using the name Manwich on the air.
Specifically Ted Anderson. Yeah. And it's, great.
Understandable.
It's great advice.
Why would they be concerned about that?
They were worried about being sued by ConAgra Foods.
All right.
And so they asked that we change his name to something else.
Okay.
And so we changed it to Mark.
Right. The one demand that our syndicate has ever had of us was probably the best advice we got.
It wasn't an unreasonable thing at all. But I think we should do something like that. Like, if we're going to have our own Warrant Canary, it should be something else that's obvious.
Where you change your name?
Yeah, but it wouldn't have to go on forever, right? Like, we could just do, if Mark all of a sudden's name is Manwich for a whole week or 2 weeks or something like that, like, that could be our Warrant Canary. And then we could, you know, switch it back. And the people who are listening often enough would know that something was up.
Yeah.
Why don't we just come up with, I mean, rather than putting ourselves in jeopardy with the Manwich thing, why don't we just come up with some new name for you? We could call you Lollipop McSugar Pants. And that would, I mean, you know, people would immediately know
too
that there's something wrong.
I'm for it. Yeah, but that's a little too long.
Too many syllables.
Which just shorten it to sugar.
All right,
McSugar
I like
pants.
That.
Sugar, sugar britches,
sugar.
All right, sugar.
I could be sugar. I could do that.
Can we all get spice names?
We should all do that. Yeah, we should.
What
all...
is that?
That's a great
cinnamon.
Idea.
Cinnamon. What are spices?
Oh, so the Spice Girls had different names.
Oh no, not like the Spice Girls did, but I just meant like general spices. Isn't sugar? Does that not count as a spice?
Sugar.
I guess sugar, spice, and everything nice is where I'm getting that from.
I don't think that would be a spice.
Yeah,
though.
I guess not. Whoops.
Yeah, how do you define a spice?
Well, I know that salt is considered a savor, not a spice. Mm-hmm. I think it's because it's mineralized. I don't know. But
this could be fun.
We'll call you mineralized. That'll be...
Well, sugar is from a plant, so I don't know. Is sugar a spice? Somebody has asked the internet this
of
already.
Of course, the internet must have been asked this.
And it's not.
Yeah,
it's... A sweetener.
Sugar does not add flavor. It is strictly for sweetening.
Doesn't add flavor.
Yes, it does. If something doesn't taste
sugar
right,
and everything
I say add
nice.
Some sugar.
Sugar was considered a spice, and it was at one point was used for some was excessively in the pursuit of good life. Sugar is not a spice. I think
the internet doesn't agree. Then,
the internet is not clear as to whether sugar is a spice or
we
not.
We need to ask Facebook and Google Plus and Twitter, although it seems like we really only get responses on Facebook.
Yeah.
These questions.
I think if
baby
Jesus were around today and the wise men had to bring him something, they would have brought him sugar this time.
Why? It's so cheap.
Well, you're right. I guess they were trying
to bring
him,
would bring him
expensive
Bitcoin.
Things. Yeah, not bad.
I think it's a good idea to have everyone on the show change their name for a certain period of time as a Warrant Canary.
As a Warrant Canary. Yeah. Just in case... So we have a like some website somewhere that tells people that we're going to change our names, or we just do it.
I can't believe that Ian wouldn't take his national security letter and just read it on the air.
Yeah, you would.
I might. I don't know.
It's pretty
but
likely.
But don't put the rest of us
federal
in jeopardy.
Prison, though. I don't
what
know.
Have you done with the real Ian? This might be the Warrant Canary. Is Ian saying maybe?
I don't know. I've never received one of those letters, so you know it could be pretty bad being locked up with Chelsea Manning. Toll-free number, 855-453. They're probably not going to keep me at the spiritual retreat for that one. It's Free Talk Live.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com. Majid lives in Nordevin, Armenia, with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Have you heard? Proactive Plus is faster and better than ever. Stay tuned for a million bottle giveaway and you'll also receive free shipping. Do you have troubled skin? Acne? Well, we have great news. With Proactive Plus, your acne can heal and you can help prevent new breakouts from happening. Don't miss this limited time offer. Give us a call at 800-538-5252 because we're going to let a million people try Proactive Plus risk-free and get two free gifts and also receive free shipping when you call right now. You heard it. This offer won't last long. So call Proactive Plus now and you'll receive a 60-day risk-free trial of Proactive Plus, two free extras, and free shipping. Call 800-538-5252. This is our exclusive radio offer, never on TV. Get your risk-free 60-day trial of Proactive Plus with free shipping. That's right, free shipping. Don't wait. Call 800-538-5252. That's 800-538-5252.
Andrew Michael Jones is a liberty-loving activist and participant in the Free State Project. He's also been accused of being one of the administrators of the infamous Silk Road Anonymous Black Marketplace. Andrew is facing a federal trial for multiple crimes with no victim. Whether or not he's the Silk Road administrator named Inigo, he has not been accused of harming anyone. In fact, the Silk Road is actually an amazing advancement that has reduced the overall harm of the black market to both customers and drug sellers. Whether or not he did it, Andrew, like alleged Silk Road founder Ross Ulbricht, deserves the support of people who love liberty. Visit drewsdefense.org to learn more and contribute to his defense. You can donate via PayPal or in Bitcoin, as I did. That's drewsdefense.org. Drew's family does not have much, and his parents have put up their home and both retirement incomes to secure a $1 million bond on Andrew. He's currently on 24/7 house arrest and is prohibited from touching any device that could connect to the internet. Please contribute to his defense fund via drewsdefense.org. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
35% of U.S. credit accounts are facing collection agencies. Of that 35, almost 40% are the result of medical bills. Before uninsured friends or family go in for medical treatment, send them to AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com. No computer tracing, no tracking cookies. They will not go on a list. Privacy matters. Just tell us what you need. Get a quote. Fractions of U.S. prices. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. And you can tell the Facebook listeners, well, the Facebook users are not necessarily listeners, because I asked the question on Facebook, if Free Talk Live changes their on-air names to Spices as a Warrant Canary, what should their Spice names be?
Sure, they don't know what the hell a Warrant Canary is.
Well,
what Spices are we referring to here?
If they were listening to the show, that question would not be hard to answer, right? Because we were talking about being, you know, pepper and salt and things like that. Although there was some dispute as to whether or not salt is a spice, paprika, etc., was
salt is not a spice.
Yeah,
sugar. Whether that was a spice or not. Because it's a plant derivative.
Mm.
So,
but the answers I've received so far, and I just literally just asked it 2 minutes ago, one person answers girls, the other scary, which is like a Spice Girl. I think they thought we were supposed to be changing our names to Spice Girls names, which is a band from pop band from the, what, the late 90s, early aughts or something.
And they didn't
like
really choose Spice names either.
No.
So the Apparently, they didn't understand the question. Anyway, if you get the question, go over to our Facebook page and drop your answer in there. What should Mark's spice name be? What should my spice name be? What would Derek J's spice name be?
White pepper. That's my name.
So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Still to come, Grover Norquist, who, you know, the name rings...
I'm taking time because I've done a hell of a lot more of it than you guys.
Yeah, Grover Norquist, a name rings a bell to me. Apparently, he's the founder and president of Americans for Tax Reform. He says libertarianism is what's coming, and we're going to get into that here when we get a chance. Your calls and thoughts are welcome. Let's, in fact, go to them. Nathan is on the line in Texas. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Nathan.
I like the sound of sugar, spice, and everything nice to start out the show with.
But, that's a little too long, though. I don't. The fewer syllables, the better, as far as I'm concerned.
Okay. Well, there's an infinite number of choices you could make. You could go with literary characters. You could be Larry L. Curly on the Sunday show. Steph and Brian and Mark could be Harry, Ron, and Hermione. But I think the best...
that's a good one.
I think the best Warrant Canary you could probably go for is something I heard from a Free Talk Live show in 2005 or something, where Mark sarcastically asked, well, how come you're not using James or Dean Martin or Frank Sinatra for the bumpers? Get rid of Holy Wars, get rid of Megadeth, get rid of Lucrezia, and just have, Frank Sinatra sing.
Uh-oh.
That would be great.
There's going to be a real problem coming up here in the future.
Yeah, we're actually going to have a music bed change.
The bumpers are going to change.
Yeah, and we don't know when it's going to go into effect, but
soon.
Yeah, it's going to happen soon.
Well, so. Free Talk Live's had the same bumpers for a dozen years.
Yeah, for a decade. Yeah.
And,
it's time for a change.
Yeah, it's time for a change.
So, Nathan, what were you calling about besides that? And no, that is not our Warrant Canary. No, so when that happens, that is not the Warrant Canary. Go ahead.
Okay. Well, it was just my idea. I mean, the other ideas I came up with weren't very good. Like have Mark not appear on the show, or have Derek J be a statist for a week, or stuff like that.
Yeah, those aren't as obvious.
I thought that was a good idea.
All right, man. Hey, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I should have asked him why he's calling on the phone lines. Normally, he calls on Skype.
We got some good suggestions from the chat room.
Yeah?
Yeah. Mark would be Angry Spice.
Or the chat room's usually listening, unlike people on Facebook. Yeah, so thank you, chatters.
Or Don't Give Caffeine Spice or Old Spice.
It doesn't have to have the word spice in it, I guess, is the point.
Right. I could just be claiming to drink some caffeinated beverage during the show. Got my Dr. Pepper right here.
All right. So
and people would be like, oh, no, this is a bad idea.
So let's talk about the future of libertarianism, because Grover Norquist over at OZY.com, site I've never heard of before, says smarter, fresher, different is their tagline. Anyway, beyond Rand Paul, the libertarians are coming. And by the way, Rand Paul is not a libertarian, nor does he claim to be a libertarian. So just put him aside. Norquist says they're no longer on the fringes. The libertarians are now officially mainstream. Proof? The New York Times Magazine cites the popularity of Republican Senator Rand Paul and opposition to American boots on the ground in Syria and Iraq. But it's much more than a moment. It's the culmination of a powerful narrative building over the past 30 years in American politics. This is a movement, and it doesn't live or die on the shoulders of one policy or one individual. So forget moment. Think trend. And consider the once impossible political shifts that have taken place over the last 30 years. The relevant dividing line is not right versus left or Republican versus Democrat, but the expansion of individual liberty versus whatever and whosoever stands in the way. The introduction of liberty as the commanding heights in American policy debates is recent, as in the last few decades, but also unique. In the past, ideas ignored or denied by the two major parties might die off or, if strong enough, spawn a successful third party. The libertarian trend has not led to a viable libertarian party, perhaps both because the right and the left have grabbed onto the emerging vote, moving issues that might have built a third party. What's notable is that regardless of whether an issue originates from the right or the left, and even though it threatens a powerful constituency in the Republican or Democratic Party structures, the side able to grab the mantle of liberty has advanced against all odds. Here are four disparate examples of radical change all headed in the same direction. 30 years ago, homeschooling was illegal in all 50 states. parents were, and occasionally still are, actually hauled off to jail for violating compulsory attendance laws. Today, homeschooling is legal and lightly regulated in all 50 states. 2 million students are being homeschooled, and 10 million Americans have been homeschooled for some part of their K-12 education. This movement had to grow powerful while still outside the law, be competent enough to defeat the teachers' unions in each state, and deliver the goods in improving education, several steep hurdles. Now that homeschooling is legal, homeschooled students seem to be winning all the spelling bees. School choice, allowing parents to choose which school they wanted for their children, public, private, or parochial, was considered beyond the pale in 1980. Now 2.6 million students have government scholarships or vouchers available to pay for their choice of education. 380,000 in Louisiana, 25,000 in Wisconsin. He goes on and lists some more states.
And I think it's important, he's listing off freedoms that we've developed in the last few decades. And I think that's really important to look at is that... there's a narrative out there that freedoms are diminishing in the United States. And I think
it depends on where you look.
Well, yeah, I think it depends on where you look. But I think if you look at the airport, that's the biggest problem. Would you agree? Can you think of other freedoms that are diminishing besides the airport? Because the airport sucks.
Well, the militarization of the police overall has diminished freedoms just on the streets of America. Look at Boston after the Boston bombing that happened last year.
Yep, I'll give you that.
And you'll see house-to-house armed searches by camo-wearing police pointing guns and rifles and things like that at people while driving Bearcats. And that's a pretty scary sight that you certainly didn't see 30 years ago. So there's that. Derek J., any obvious...
No, I'm trying to think of some, but I feel like I have no history to draw on. Well, you know, like, I don't really know what it was like before. Like, I was shocked to hear that homeschooling wasn't around 30 years ago. I thought that's always been the case.
The debt doesn't really affect the Americans on a day-to-day basis, but it has grown tremendously over the past two presidents. And that's... you know, what that does is that worries me about the future for future Americans.
It certainly makes life harder to go about living because the cost of living will go up as a result of the government's monetary policy.
Or they'll just continue to stack debt upon debt.
So 40 states have a total of 6,640 charter schools, and in New Orleans, 90% of students attend charter schools. 30 years ago, there were actually laws criminalizing gays. Gay Americans often lived in fear of legal and social opprobrium. The closet was real because it was safer. State by state, city by city, blue laws were repealed or struck down by courts. The culture and our laws opened up. Once unthinkable, now gay marriage appears inevitable. Attitudes toward gay Americans have shifted dramatically. Yes, the courts drove some of these changes, but public opinion has also shifted dramatically over the decades. The drive for gay rights has moved quickly. And yet, when some politicians have demanded that gay rights means a Christian florist or minister has to participate in a gay wedding against his religious beliefs, the pendulum appears to stop and may swing back. Why? Because freedom of religion then trumps you do what I want. The team that frames its side as defending and expanding liberty will win.
Yeah, and I'll tell you that that whole forcing people to do what's against their religion because gay marriage is now legal thing, really, it really makes me regret the support that I have given to gay marriage is that, you know, look, see what happens when we give, give people rights under the law. This is why
that shouldn't make you regret supporting gay marriage. That just should make you oppose the idea of forcing someone against their will to do business with someone they don't want to do business with. It has nothing to do with gay marriage.
But supporting it under the color of law gives it a whole new set of...
I don't want to sell anything to anyone who's married, I should not have to be selling that.
Agreed, 100%.
We'll come back with more here in moments. Hour number three is on the way, and we'll get our comments from our token gay guy in the studio here tonight. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up. Hour three is on the way.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Kane in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, September 29th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.58 per ounce. Gold's valued at $1,221 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $379. Antiwar.com reports, as the Shiite Houthi movement continues to expand its control over the Yemeni capital of Sana'a, they are quickly attracting the attention of southern Islamist factions, including Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula. Yesterday, a suicide bomber from Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula drove a car bomb into the Houthi-controlled hospital in the Marib province, killing at least 15 people and wounding 50 others, according to the locals. The Yemeni government has sought to keep the Houthis confined to their far north provinces by encouraging Islamist factions to move into the areas near them. After weeks of fighting, the Houthis routed them and moved on to the capital. As their control grows, they're now facing some protest. A small protest was organized in Sana'a, though organizers claimed the turnout was kept low because of the Houthi presence across the city, which kept many leaders from showing up. The Houthis claimed a deal to form a new consensus government, and government officials said they thought that would include the Houthis leaving Sana'a. So far, that doesn't seem to be panning out, and the tensions in the capital continue to rise. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. Reuters reports, Afghanistan inaugurates its first new president in a decade today, swearing in technocrat Ashraf Ghani to head a power-sharing government just as the withdrawal of most foreign troops presents a crucial test. The first democratic handover of power in Afghanistan's history has been far from smooth. The deal for a unity government was cobbled together only after months of deadlock over a vote in which both Ghani and opponent Abdullah Abdullah claimed victory. The inauguration marks the end of an era with the departure of President Hamid Karzai, the only leader Afghans have known since a U.S.-led invasion in 2001 overthrew the Taliban that had given sanctuary to Al-Qaeda. The already tight security was heightened around the capital of Kabul ahead of the inauguration for fear that Taliban insurgents might try to disrupt the ceremony or attack international dignitaries who flew in to attend. Both foreign backers and Afghans hope that Ghani and Abdullah can put aside their acrimonious election rivalry and work to improve life in a country that has suffered war and poverty for decades. The new government inherits massive problems, including fighting an emboldened Taliban that in recent months has been launching ever more aggressive attacks attacks as foreign troops draw down. Ghani must also reset relations with the United States, which has soured in recent years under Karzai. One of Ghani's first acts as president is expected to be signing a bilateral security agreement to allow a small contingent of U.S. forces to remain to train and assist the new Afghan army and police. Karzai had refused to sign it, but both Ghani and Abdullah are in favor of signing it promptly. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. The Associated Press reports, pro-democracy protest expanded in Hong Kong on Monday, a day after demonstrators, upset over Beijing's decision to limit political reforms, defied onslaughts of tear gas and appeals from Hong Kong's top leaders to go home. And with rumors swirling, Hong Kong's chief executive, Leong Chong-ying, reassured the public that speculation that the Chinese army might intervene was untrue. The city's transport department said that besides road closures in some areas, such as the Causeway Bay, where protests have been focused, main roads have also been blocked by demonstrators in Mong Kok. More than 200 bus routes have been canceled or diverted in a city dependent on public transportation. Subway exits had also been closed or blocked near protest areas. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Zoo visitors watch the mating rituals of the ice cream shop staff, and a serious coworker puts on headphones to focus on his sandwich. Happiness is perpetually fleeting, so try to savor the next few minutes before it disappears once again. This is the Onion Week in Review. FBI officials announced they just can't bring themselves to bust a man who recently downloaded every season of the 1990s television show Picket Fences from a BitTorrent website. While stressing that pirating copyrighted material is strictly illegal, federal authorities expressed their sympathy for the man and claimed that perhaps the story of Sheriff Jimmy Brock and the strange events in a small Wisconsin town is all he has left to cling to.
We have more than enough evidence to bust him for piracy, but if the poor guy really wants to watch all four seasons of a 20-year-old CBS drama that nobody remembers, he's clearly going through a pretty big rough patch right now. Frankly, we don't need to make it any worse.
For statistical purposes, we have seized all private data from your personal computer, and we are disgusted with your recent internet search history. You sick f***. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
Free Talk Live. You dial toll-free, you take control of the airwaves. That's how it works around here. It's pretty simple. The number's 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have waiting for you on the site. Once again, freetalklive.com. The we includes me, Ian.
Derek J.
And Mark.
And don't forget to go check out Derek J's redesigned website, derekj.me. It's free, of course, and you can watch his free movie and listen to all kinds of radio shows that he does, because he's not just here on Free Talk Live. He also does Peace News Now twice a week.
Cop Block Radio, Freedom Fiends, and a bunch of other shows.
Bitcoin show, Bitcoin talk show?
Bitcoin talk show, yep.
And aren't you on like some second Bitcoin-related show?
Yeah, I'm a guest host on the Bitcoin group. It's like a knockoff of the McLaughlin group, but Bitcoin-themed.
Very cool. So all of that and more, including blogs and videos and things like that, over at derekj.me. So we were just commenting on this Grover Norquist piece where he's identifying a few different things where freedom has progressed, because it's easy for us to look at the negatives around us. It's easy to see the police state, to see the military tanks, the crazy incarceration rates. I mean, the United States, of course, is one of the worst places, if not the worst place in the developed world to live, as far as, you know, you're very likely here compared to other places to get arrested for something, some nonsense victimless crime. The jails and prisons are loaded up with innocent, peaceful people who've never harmed anybody, and there's a significant amount of that going on here, and it's gotten worse over time. The war on drugs, of course, prohibition, you know, the alcohol prohibition went away, but it was replaced with drug prohibition, which has not gotten better. There's not more freedom in that realm. So it's easy to point out all the negatives, the bombings going on around the world, etc. But Norquist is pointing out a few of the positives here and how it is that the advocates for freedom in some areas have have won the day. And he gives homeschooling as an example. Apparently, I didn't know this. I didn't know homeschooling was illegal 50 years ago or in the 1950s. Yeah, no, 30 years ago, he says, homeschooling was illegal in all 50 states, which was a shocker to me.
Which means that parents were homeschooling their kids because homeschooling didn't just become a thing because the government said, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. It means that
they were doing
brave
it.
Yeah. People said, I refuse to send my kids to school. I want to educate them myself. Likely, in many cases, religious people. But I just... I'm always amused by the law and order crowd who tends to be sort of religious and usually the mainstream, you know, sort of religions that people are familiar with because, you know, that's the kind of people they are. They're law and order folks. They're conservative. And, you know, let's point out here, many of these law and order folks be very pro homeschool, but it was civil disobedience that brought you homeschooled.
Yep, and he also talks about how gay marriage is now much more acceptable, and just being gay publicly in general is much more acceptable. And Derek J., you've been gay your whole life. How's that make you feel?
It's good, although I've always felt very accepted. I know there are other parts of the country where people aren't as accepting.
It's certainly harder in certain parts. Maybe the Bible Belt, for instance, might be a little harder to be an out gay, but it would have been a lot harder 30 years ago, right?
Yeah.
Wherever you lived.
But I attribute that victory to cultural wins and the bravery of individuals sharing their lives, their personal lives, their loves with their friends and family and neighbors, because it's those types of people who really change hearts and minds, not politicians who say, oh, okay, gay marriage is fine.
Well, right, the politicians, they don't lead the parades, right? They run out in front of the parade to make it look like they've been leading the parade the whole time.
They've got their thumb to the wind, and
yes,
they're listening to see, you know, what are the gay people thinking? What are the average folks thinking about the gays? Is it okay now? And
a decade or two behind. They're at least two, if not three decades behind society, I would say.
Yeah, so once society is cool with it, then the politicians are ready to jump on board and say, yay, rights for gays. Meanwhile, we've all been on that same page for years.
Yeah, and we're seeing the same thing with marijuana laws, too.
Although the author of this article points out something troubling about the gay rights issue, which is like right after we saw, you know, gays are having their day, mm-hmm. marriage everywhere, they're on TV, hooray, that's great. But then some people are taking advantage of this, saying, well, now you have to make us cakes. Now you have to do our wedding ceremony. We have to be allowed to have a wedding on your private property. And that really upsets me, because it seems like these people they don't value private property.
No, just because you're gay doesn't mean you value private property, right?
Right, yeah.
Or that you understand what liberty really means. You may want liberty for yourself, but you may not understand how that really translates into you have to allow others to be free, which means you would have to allow the bigot to have his own business and make his bigoted cakes. And
this comes down to
you
forcing people into a new paradigm. This is creating a new world order, as it were, as opposed to increasing freedom. I want gay people to be able to contract with each other, to live together, if that's what they want to do. I want them to be able to do that. However, I don't think anybody should be forced to recognize it or do anything else. Like, mm-hmm. my marriage should not compel you to do anything.
That's right. It should.
My marriage should, maybe if you run a hospital, allow you, allow my wife to come visit me in ways that maybe other people shouldn't, or something like that. But that's really the end of it for me, whereas other people will use it as a cudgel to force things upon you.
Yeah, that's the sort of what I'm talking about. Like, I was disheartened to see, because I consider, like, my gay family, you know, everyone who's gay in some news story somewhere, I'm like, well, I've got something in common with them and I can relate. So, but when I hear these stories of people saying, well, now you have to make us cakes, oh man, it's so disheartening, because come on, guys, you just won a little bit of freedom. Is it really time to throw the authoritarian hammer around?
Well, the fact is, just because someone's gay doesn't mean they're not an authoritarian, right? I mean, just like, there's all kinds of brilliant authoritarians out there, and they have come up with amazingly smart ways to control our lives. And so I wouldn't want those people in my family, regardless of what their preferences.
Yeah.
So we continue here. A few points. He's got a couple other things on, you know, this is what has progressed over time, over the last few decades, because freedom, he argues, wins over the years. 30 years ago, he says, 80% of Americans supported stricter gun control laws. Certain guns were banned. Organizations formed and expected they would soon ban handguns in private hands. In 1987, Florida passed a shall-issue concealed carry law that required local government to give any honest and sane adult a permit to carry a gun concealed on his or her person or in a purse or car.
I love how we can stipulate that honest and sane adults can have guns. Well, who decides who's sane? Who decides who's honest?
The government.
Right.
Well, it's not perfect, that's for sure.
No, I understand, but I just, it's always amuses me. At this point, the government seems to be, there's no other way to disarm the American populace, so they're just going to make everybody a felon.
They don't let these things go easily. There's no doubt that this has been a slow, arduous process that obviously he's summing up in a paragraph or two, decades of very tough work and difficulty that has resulted in these social changes. I mean, it's a messy process. Like right now, Derek J., you have been denied your supposed right to carry a firearm in one of the what is ostensibly the most gun freedom oriented states in the union.
Live free or die.
They've told you no. And there's a, what they call a shall issue permit here in New Hampshire. And now you're having to hire a multi-thousand-dollar attorney just to take this denial to court to try to retain your rights. So it's a messy process getting from here, which is more restrictions, to there, which is fewer restrictions.
I'm shocked that the author is actually making the claim that there's more gun freedom now than there was in the past. It's not like I was around in the past.
No, there's more gun freedom now than there was in the past.
He says today, 41 states have enacted such laws. In 2007, there were 4.5 million such permits, and today there are more than 11.1 million permits. Arizona, Vermont, Wyoming, and Alaska don't even require permits to carry for their citizens, and 5% of the adult population has a concealed carry permit, one out of 20 people. This drive has been fueled and validated by the fact that violent crime falls faster in states with concealed carry laws, and even faster as more citizens avail themselves of that new, he puts in quotes, right. Now, we know that's not a right, okay? That if it were a right to carry a firearm, as it should be, as the Constitution and, you know, the Second Amendment.
You don't have to ask permission for a right.
Exactly. So
that's it. That's the end of the story. You know you have a right because you don't have to ask permission for it. You don't have to ask the government to breathe or blink or do a variety of things. But, you know, your right to carry arms, that's a attenuated right. Well, what's that mean? We tell you when you can do it, how you can do it, and if you can do it.
It ain't true gun freedom yet in most places, but his argument is that it's moving slowly in that direction. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE, and coming up, his final point. It's Free Talk Live.
Hi, Chuck Woolery here. I don't know about you, but I don't like taking pills for minor arthritis pain, and I don't like those patches either. But I have found something that works, Australian Dream Arthritis Pain Relief Cream. It's a great product. It doesn't smell or burn, isn't greasy, and it works. And Australian Dream has an empty jar guarantee. You can use the whole jar, and if you're not happy, you get your money back. But I doubt you'll send it back. This stuff really works. Australian Dream is now available at Target or your favorite retail store.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Jim Newcomer from Midas Resources, July 5th, 2012. Gold opened this morning at $1,613. A one-ounce gold coin can be purchased for $1,653.42, $826.71 for a half ounce, or $413.36 for a quarter ounce. That's $1,653.42, $826.71, and $413.36.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? Wait a sec. Gold and silver is going up while Congress is trying to settle on the next debt increase. And there's no end end to this madness. That old 401k and IRA can be converted into physical gold without tax consequences. I explained this in my book, 10 Reasons to Buy Gold. Don't let time slip away. Call for your free copy today, 800-686-2237. Get away from that Washington spin and get honest answers about gold. 800-686-2237. The book is free, 800-686-2237.
Researchers at Princeton University's Department of Sociology have made a major leap in our understanding of social interaction.
We conducted trials in 90 supermarkets across the country and found that essentially 100% of people disapproved of having a stranger hit them across the face and then expose their genitalia right in the middle of the supermarket, which we found very interesting.
Researchers observed similar reactions when the subject hurled shopping carts toward unsuspecting shoppers, stood in the deli section rubbing cold cuts against his chest, or got right near cashier's ears and began loudly singing Yankee Doodle.
In this particular trial, we had our subject, Kevin, take off his shirt, tape a banana to his forehead, and charge at various shoppers like he was a rhino. Within 20 minutes, store owners called the police and he was arrested, allowing us to come to the conclusion that this type of behavior is still considered at least somewhat taboo.
This is the Onion News Network.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free here. The number is 855-450-FREE. We're sharing a story from Grover Norquist over at OZY.com. He's talking about how he believes that freedom is winning the day overall, that libertarianism is what's next, and that it's coming, and he cites some examples where freedom has won over the years, and it's nice to have that sort of positive perspective, and I appreciate that because it's easy to get mired down in all the negativity when, you know, it's easier to see the stuff that's bad, I think, in the world, and it's good to focus on things that are worth appreciating. So we're going to continue that here in a moment, but maybe you have something you want to add to this list, because we've talked about, gay marriage, respecting and appreciating, you know, and allowing gay people to, you know, to be out rather than oppressing them. We've talked about gun rights being on the rise over time, and also homeschooling also being on the rise, going from apparently completely illegal just 30 years ago. So there's been some progress. But what are we missing? What's left off the list here? I'm sure there's something else you want to share your thoughts. Please do with us here at 855-450-FREE. That's toll-free, 855-450-3733. And if you value your online privacy, and this could be an area, right, like the internet, that has led to a lot more freedom in a lot of ways, then you need to know about ProXPN, because there certainly are forces out there who would like to destroy privacy on the internet, and you have to take steps to protect it. You can't trust the mega corporations to do it for you, and you certainly can't trust your internet service provider. They're probably logging every website you visit and every search term that you enter, and maybe keeping those logs for as long as 5 years in some cases. So go to proxpn.com/FTL, where you can download their free software for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, and Android devices. devices. Linux users, you can get it set up as well. It's just a little bit of a different setup for you. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. Grab the software, get started for free. And when you're ready to upgrade to get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can connect to, private torrenting ability, plus you can get past regionally blocked websites with ProXPN with their premium account. So when you're ready to upgrade, use our discount codes. FTL50, that's FTL like Free Talk Live, and the number 50, gets you 50% off the price of the annual account, and that is good for the lifetime of your account. Plus, you can use code FTLBTC to save even more. You'll save 62% with code FTLBTC, and you pay with Bitcoin in that case. Again, that's on the annual account price. So go and get set up with proxpn.com/FTL and use our codes FTL50 or FTLBTC. By the way, you get a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. ProXPN is a great discount on privacy that is priceless. So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Join us on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. The final point on Grover Norquist's list of things that he's observing is being more free now than in our lifetimes, actually, is marijuana. 30 years ago, marijuana was illegal as medicine or even as a recreational use drug in all 50 states. Today, 21 states allow the use of medical marijuana, and now, of course, Colorado and Washington state have legalized its sale for any purpose. Full state legalization will be on the ballot in Oregon and Alaska in 2014, and likely California, Arizona, and others in 2016. In Congress, the House of Representatives in 2010 voted to scale back its 100-to-1 ratio of punishment for crack cocaine versus white powder cocaine. This backing off of the widening anti-drug war of the 1980s was made possible by a unanimous vote in the House. I have to say, I didn't hear about that news.
Yeah, what unanimous vote?
Apparently a unanimous vote to scale back the punishment for crack versus cocaine.
I think I remember Rand Paul being behind this. Am I wrong? Are the years wrong on that?
I don't have... it says they voted in 2010.
So it could have been.
Was he around there then?
2010? It would have been close.
Feel free to check that out and pull up more info about that vote. I'm fascinated that it was unanimous. Anyway, he says one no vote could have killed the unanimous consent needed. Why would they have needed a unanimous consent for that? I'm confused. I need to know more about that. Anyway, he goes on to say, now three states are pushing policies called the right to try. These state laws in Colorado, Louisiana, and Missouri legalize new drugs now deemed safe by the Food and Drug Administration, but not yet deemed to be effective. Arizona may become the fourth state this fall. This deregulation speeds up the ability of sick Americans to get possible life-saving drugs years sooner.
Was it the California Senate or the U.S. Senate?
It says here it was Congress, the House of Representatives.
Okay.
In 2010. Anyway, the deregulation speeds up the ability for sick Americans to get life-saving drugs sooner than the FDA allows. The stoners opened a door that may improve and perhaps save the lives of many ill Americans. Drugs, parents saying no to public schools, guns, gays. Could there be more controversial, he puts in quotes, public issues? And yet all moved in the same direction over 30 years of American politics from Reagan to Obama. These four radical, unthinkable expansions of individual liberty are not liberal or conservative, Republican or Democrat. All flow from the small L, libertarian, live and let live, leave us alone, laissez-faire attitude. Four movements calling for increased individual liberty, while their opponents explained, with hundreds if not thousands of years of tradition and history to back them up, that society should have the power to control behavior for the public good. One can see other issues that follow this trend. Uber against the taxi regulators, Airbnb, Lyft, bet and invest on the side of advancing liberty. A libertarian moment? No. A trend. A long-term trend with no obvious roadblock in sight.
All right. Oh, it's great. I like the way he puts that.
Yeah, it's great. It's a positive message, and I think that you take that news, you combine it with the Free State Project, mm-hmm. where we're actually getting real libertarian thinkers together and doers all in the same place, and think about what's going to happen here in New Hampshire in the next 10, 20, 30 years. I mean, that gets really exciting, because what he's pointing out here is all of this liberty-oriented stuff has happened. It's taken decades, But it's happened over time, and it's been brought about not by libertarians. These, you know, the people that have put forth these changes haven't been libertarians. They've just been responding to the market demand to some extent, that slow political change that takes forever to happen, that, as we were talking about earlier, trails what society actually wants, but eventually kind of catches up when some of the older people die off. That's happening already without libertarians actually winning public office. So when libertarians start to get elected, will we see this accelerate? Will we see that happen here in New Hampshire? Will we see politics follow a little closer to society in New Hampshire than it does in the rest of the country? And what will that end up looking like? I'm excited to find out.
Gosh, I hope so. I would like to see a situation where maybe the politicians are ahead of the people, where they've got too much, they allow too much freedom. That maybe
you're a dreamer.
Indeed.
Yeah.
All right, fine.
But that's good. You got to dream big, right? Like, you know, even if we get halfway to that point, that would be pretty great.
Yeah.
And it would really put New Hampshire out above the pack. And in fact, when New Hampshire becomes more obviously free, it's already arguably the most free of all the 50 states, but when it becomes the clear most free state.
I don't want it to be close.
Yeah.
I don't want it to be arguable.
Right. So when it becomes the clear most free state, then we'll start to attract even more people to come here, because not everybody wants to be on the, you know, they don't want to be on the cutting edge. They don't want to be the pioneers like we are. We're the early movers for the Free State Project. You know, we moved before the Free State Project even completed its 20,000. We're still working towards the 20,000 people to sign up for the Free State Project, which you can do at freestateproject.org. But after the 20,000, you know, then there's going to be more people coming, because this will become a more attractive, more free place to be. And that'll result in more wonderful developments that we can't even envision today. Share your thoughts.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX, or my website, danpilla.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom workers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
The Shire Free Church offers a sanctuary to those seeking an escape from state churches.
The Shire Free Church is an interfaith, diverse group of people that may not share identical theological beliefs. As a member in or minister of the Shire Free Church, you are a sovereign individual and may be the faith of your choice.
We don't claim to have all of the answers.
We are open to all peaceful people.
We want to learn from each other.
What unifies the Shire Free Church and its diverse members is peace,
love, and liberty. There are many paths to God, one for every individual.
The Shire Free Church does not define a specific path beyond those parameters that must be your foundation.
Peace as your way,
love as your guide,
and liberty as your light.
Learn more at church.shiresociety.com.
That's church.shiresociety.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
It's Free Talk Live. Dial here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us via Skype. Our Skype username, it's lrn.fm. You know, here on Free Talk Live, we like alternative currencies, gold, silver. You can go and get all the gold and silver you could possibly desire from gold.freetalklive.com. Our friends over at Midas Resources will hook you up. But what if you want to get Bitcoin, Mark? That's another great alternative currency.
Great place to do it is expresscoin.com. They make it fast, easy, legal, completely legal. They have a licensed MSB. Inexpensive. They pride themselves in their customer service. Go check them out at expresscoin.com. You can make a deposit at a local credit union that has shared branching and have your Bitcoins within a business day. Now, you can also do it with a money order check or wire transfer if you want to do it that way. That's fine, too. I've done lots of business with ExpressCoin.com. You can trust them. Whether you want to get Bitcoins or Dogecoin or Litecoin or Blackcoin or Darkcoin, they make all those cryptocurrencies available to you. If you live in the United States or Canada, use coupon code FTL at ExpressCoin.com, and you can get up to $40 worth of Bitcoin at no fee. It's coupon code FTL, ExpressCoin.com.
All right, so we're going to continue with your calls, and then Derek J. will be telling us about these busybody college bureaucrats who are really getting into the personal sex lives of their students.
Mm-hmm.
We'll get into that here in a moment. Let's go first, though, to Jones, calling from Arizona. Jones, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Jones.
It's James.
Oh, hey, James, you're on the air. Go ahead.
And I don't call Free Talk Live, so called. To get any goat or to get underneath anybody's skin. I just call in when I disagree with, sometimes strongly, your so-called minister friend over there who was, calls himself a minister and doesn't want to talk to me because he's so filled with hate. I don't know any minister that I've ever met that wouldn't want to talk to somebody that he hated, let alone thought that they were insane or maniac or all that.
Actually, just to be clear, James, he did talk to you the last two times you called in.
No, he didn't. No, he didn't. He talked over me. Just like I was trying to ask a rhetorical question last time I called in about the reason why you can't find any pictures on the internet of Christians chopping off people's heads, like Mark butted in to remark to me that there were. The reason why you can't find any pictures of people, Christians chopping people's heads up is because there haven't been Christians like that for like 1,000 years.
Well, so actually, it's funny you bring that up, James. It's funny that you bring that up because I've actually got a story
about
that.
Stupid point.
Yeah, I got you. But I'm responding now to your point because we're going to have a conversation here. And it's funny that you bring that up because I actually had in my show prep for tonight a story from the London Evening Standard where Jennifer Mills Wetsley, age 60, was repeatedly stabbed and beheaded while shopping in a popular resort of Los Cristianos. Homeless Bulgarian drug addict Dejan Denanov, age 29, has denied murdering the grandmother of five from Norwich at his trial at the provincial court in Santa Cruz. Answering questions in Bulgarian with the help of interpreter, he did tell the court that he is haunted by voices in his head which tell him how to act. He claimed they told him he was an angel of Jesus Christ who is going to create a new Jerusalem. So it sounds to me like you've got an individual here who believes that he's a Christian who may have actually beheaded a woman. So there's one example for you, James. Maybe it just doesn't get the reporting that
Will Connolly or any other Christian would call him a sociopath, not a Christian. But ISIS is for real, and they really are chopping people's heads off because they believe God commanded them to do such. Because they have read the Quran, and they do believe the passages in the burnt Quran that command them to do that. And they believe it wholeheartedly as you.
There was no command like that in the Quran that I read. Thanks for the call tonight. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. We had, by the way, for listeners just tuning in tonight, grab our Saturday show from this week. Go to freetalklive.com. We actually had a Muslim on the line with us for 3 hours on Saturday night. He fielded every question you could possibly imagine, at least that all of our listeners could imagine on that one night, about being a Muslim and, you know, what does the Quran actually say, and are Muslims violent, and do they hate women, and, you know, all kinds of those issues were addressed.
And we had a meme on our Facebook page, facebook.freetalklive.com, that showed some what appeared to be ISIS folks in a kneeling down in sort of a 90-degree angle to do their daily prayers. Anybody who knows anything about Islam knows that you're supposed to kneel towards Mecca. Mm-hmm. And if you're in a 90-degree angle, somebody, at the very least, half of the people are not kneeling towards Mecca. So one really has to sort of question how good are these Muslims that are, like, you know, there's lots of people in the U.S. military that call themselves Christians. That doesn't mean that people believe the U.S. military is prosecuting Christian wars. But one of the things that Will Coley said during his long interview with us was that that nationalism is counter to Islam. That Sharia law that, is Islam, basically says that nationalism shouldn't exist, that your loyalties should lie to God. And that, when it comes down to a religion, there's many Christian religions that believe the same thing. What comes to mind are Jehovah's Witnesses aren't supposed to vote, nor are Amish, Mennonites, Quakers, I know that are against saying like the pledge, things like that.
Anybody who's read the Quran knows that it's really almost like a continuation of the Bible. It's sort of like, you know, part two, sort of essentially the story being that the angel Gabriel, the same one, appeared to Muhammad and gave him some corrections.
That's his claim. Yeah.
Essentially gave him some corrections. Hey, you know, the Bible editors kind of got this information wrong, so you need to put this out there. That was sort of the basis for Islam. So there's, but again, I can't do it justice. I've done a cursory examination compared to Will Coley from Muslims for Liberty. He was on our show with us Saturday night this last weekend. So just go to freetalklive.com, download that at your convenience, and it's very enlightening. Dana is with us listening from, I'm not sure where, Maine? Jefferson, Maine? I'm not real sure where you are. Dana, where are you at?
Jefferson, Maine.
Okay, great. Go ahead.
Yeah, I have this typed out, so forgive me. This is the first time for me calling into any radio station.
Well,
sure, go right
ahead.
So
the topic that I wanted to talk about is body alterations. Pretty much I have a couple questions that I want to go and ask you guys, but let me just read off what I have right here. There are many personal reasons why people wish to alter their bodies, like, for example, piercings, tattoos, and changing one's gender. There are even certain groups of people who dream for the day when science and technology can make it possible to achieve whatever advanced genetically engineered alterations they wish to be done to their body. My two questions to you guys are, what are your thoughts on this topic, and would there be a market for this interest in a liberty-based community?
Well, there's a huge market for tattoos and piercings all across the United States, and certainly that applies within the Liberty community. I know there have been tattoo artists who have come to the Porcupine Freedom Festival offering their services to people. The Porcupine Freedom Festival is a yearly festival the Free State Project throws up here in New Hampshire that actually you could probably easily attend living in Maine. But the tattoo artists who've come to these festivals have been booked solid the entire time, so I would say it's a fairly high interest interest in the liberty community in body modification. And then your other question was sort of just a general question about how we feel about it. General, guys, would you like to field that?
Well, I think that it's interesting that body modifications have become more and more popular throughout my lifetime. A tattoo, when I was a kid, would have been relegated to somebody in the military or a biker. Like it was not a common thing. You know, you might see like a butterfly on a woman's ankle or leg or something like that. But really,
I saw a cop with a tattoo today.
Right, it's just not really very common. It wasn't very common. So tattoos kind of picked up, as did piercings. You know, and I live a relatively conservative lifestyle. I'm not big into this stuff. So people that have these big gauge piercings and things like that, none of it makes any sense to me at all. But that's their body and their life. I think that in a liberty-oriented community, or community that believed in the ideas of liberty, you'd probably see an acceleration and a diversification in this area. So, yeah, I think it would be a big deal, and people would like it a lot.
We'll come back with more. Dana, thanks for the call tonight. The toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. We'll get Derek J's thoughts coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online, and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Question. Could too many GMO foods and toxins be overloading your digestive and immune systems? Answer, yes. If you're searching for a powerful detox that's gentle enough to use every day, use Pro-EM1 from Terriganics. Pro-EM1 is a powerful liquid probiotic that uses good bacteria to suppress pathogens and gently eliminate toxins from your body. A healthy digestive system will cleanse and remove toxins, support weight loss, improve absorption of food nutrients, and aid in controlling yeast and other infections. Pro-EM1 is made with only non-GMO and certified organic ingredients, has no preservatives, and is dairy, soy, wheat, and gluten-free. Pro-EM1 is the key to your digestive health. Order Pro-EM1 Daily Probiotic Cleanse at Terraganix.com, spelled TERRAGANIX.com. Or call toll-free 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Also available through Amazon Prime. Pro-EM1 from Terraganix. Life's getting better.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippie! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Woo! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Take control. Toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com. And please enjoy the features that we have waiting for you there. Hey, if you like Free Talk Live and you want to help support the show, well, you can do that by shopping with us at shop.freetalklive.com. Enter Amazon through the links you'll find there. There's Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, and Amazon US. You just go and get your shopping taken care of. Free Talk Live gets a cut of the purchase. And Keenvention is coming up here in about a month, as a matter of fact, happening October 31st through November 2nd. There's a lot going to be happening in one weekend here in beautiful Keene, New Hampshire. It's a great excuse to come up and check out New Hampshire and meet some of the very same activists that you hear on this show and you hear talked about on this show. We are excited about the liberty movement here in New Hampshire, and Keenvention is the convention that focuses on that. Now, the Free State Project throws a couple great great events every year up here, and I recommend attending those as well if you can afford it. There's, of course, the Liberty Forum in the wintertime, which is coming up in March, I think, this coming year. And then there's also the Porcupine Freedom Festival in the summertime. Great events, but they don't focus entirely on the activism scene in New Hampshire, and that's what Keenvention does. Plus, we throw in some fun events like Galactic Bowling and Karaoke on Saturday night and the brand new Hallokeen Dance Party.
Yeah.
I hear rumors there are going to be lasers at the Hallokeen Dance Party, so we're going to be having a lot of fun on Friday night, and you're going to be involved in that, Derek J. And we've got a couple more announcements to make about the Hallokeen Dance Party, which I'm excited about, but we're not going to break the news right now. You can go and get your tickets for Keenvention at keenvention.info for $60. That gets you in for the entire weekend, and it also you can pay for it in Bitcoin as well. So, plus, if you want to know what it was like last year, you can go to keenvention.info, and you can actually watch videos from all of the speeches, all of the panel discussions. It's all been recorded and preserved for you to enjoy, even if you weren't actually there. So go to keenvention.info. You want to come because it's more fun to be there in person, where you can actually connect with these people. You get to stand there and ask the questions. That way you can be seen on the videos this year. So come on up and check out Keenvention, keenvention.info. We look forward to seeing you October 31st through November 2nd in our very own beautiful Keene, New Hampshire. All right, so let's see. We were talking about, we had a gentleman, I think, call in just—
Yeah, he wanted to talk about body modifications.
Body alteration was the term that he used. Derek J., care to comment on that? And just the general question about how you feel about it was sort of the question he asked.
Yeah, I like them. I'm a fan. Since I was 18, started engaging in some body modification with piercings, lip piercings and stuff. And always found it to be a form of expression. I think, you know, when I brought it up with my parents, they said, yeah, people have been modifying their bodies for all of history.
Yeah.
You know, you can look back at different cultures and see they're putting bowls in their tongues and different things.
Whatever it takes to sort of separate you from the other guy.
Yeah, it's just a way to be ornamental. And like, I like that. I wear rings. I want to decorate my body. I want to stand out. Like, you know, just be different, and it's fun. So I'm pro body modification. I know some people think about tattoos like, oh, it's harkening back to the Holocaust. Why would anyone want to mark their bodies like that? You know,
weird. Especially I've never heard that one.
This is an objection I hear frequently about tattoos. Another is that if you go to jail, you'll be easily recognized because they mark what sort of body modifications.
They certainly
you've
will
got.
Do that. That's and 100% so, true.
Yes.
They also mark you if you get a scar or something like that as well.
That's true.
Yep. So, you know, I'm pro body modification. I think in a free society, since he went there, I think there would be more body modification, not less, because I don't know.
Well, there's still some societal oppression against this, right? Like in some jobs, for instance, you can't have tattoos showing. You know, you have to wear long sleeves if you got them on your arms, that kind of thing. Some jobs wouldn't want you to have like a nose piercing or something like that. Ear piercings, those have been accepted for a long time. Those you'll probably be fine with. But there's certain things that just haven't gotten to the level of full-on societal acceptance yet.
And they just haven't gotten there yet. It just takes people to push that envelope. Like, mm-hmm. I was one. When I worked at Greenpeace, I wore my lip rings. And so, you know, I was walking there, raising money, talking to random strangers on the street while I've got these rings popping out of my mouth. And
now,
like,
you don't do that now.
I don't do that. It broke my teeth. So
it broke your teeth?
Yeah. So
did you,
that's
like,
one of the
smash
reasons
into them somehow? How did they break your teeth?
This is really painful, so just hang in there.
Oh,
I hope you're sitting. I bit down and just broke them. Like, it was... Yep, you can imagine.
Total
the pain
accident.
Was intense, and I just never wanted to have that happen again. So I took them out, and I think they're beautiful. I think they're sexy.
Hmm. So are broken teeth.
Yeah, but broken teeth are not worth the price.
Yeah, okay, I've got a couple of tattoos, got them in prison, done with, made, one of them made with what we called, I can't remember, basically you took the soot from some burning razors and, you know, scraped it off of some place and then mixed it with some shampoo, and you had something that would be used as tattoo ink. The other case, we smuggled in some India ink and got them. And
sweet.
Whenever I think about my tattoos, I wish they were gone. They're not really of any use to me.
Well, that's a problem with tattoos in a lot of ways, is when you get one at a young age, maybe you'll change and then later on not really appreciate what it was that you'd
gotten. But that's why I'm really against these gauged ear piercings and that sort of thing. Because
hard to reverse those,
if I want to not be tattooed, I put on a shirt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I had it, you know, I was at least smart enough that a t-shirt was going to cover my tattoos no matter what they were. And I thought about getting other tattoos, but, you know, I mean, it's you only want the tattoo you want now, and you generally do not want the tattoo that you have for very long. It's a pretty rare circumstance. Mm-hmm. So I'm against tattoos as a piece of advice.
You were an anarcho-communist when you were a teenager, and a lot of times
I almost got a red Circle A tattoo.
Wow.
I intended to do it on my 18th birthday.
Sickle, I guess.
The guy refused to do it.
Wow.
Really?
Yeah.
You lucked out.
So if I had gone someplace
else... Why did he refuse?
He said that he was scared the anarchists would do something that would get... I would be somehow branded as one of them, and so therefore he didn't want to be involved.
Look, kid, I don't want your money. Get out of here.
He didn't. Yeah. I was there. I had my money. I had my the picture. I had everything, and he didn't want it.
That's interesting.
Wow. I got my piercings done with a couple of friends who swore that they would be the cool leather jacket-wearing pierced old guy in the nursing home. Like, yeah, I was so cool. And they already regret their gauges. They're, you know, they've got those big holes in their ears that are big
loops.
They
just hang there now.
They never seal. And
they're never going to seal.
No, they look very ugly and they regret it, and there's nothing they could do.
Yeah, I think you got to put a lot of thought and time into this stuff. Don't do it real haphazard.
Some people really like this, and I think that you'll probably see more body modifications in a freer world.
Sure.
Because they'll become more and more accepted.
Well, I think that's true, and I know we're seeing that over time anyway, and that's great. Do you have any tattoos, Derek J?
I don't have any tattoos. I have my nipples pierced. That's pretty intense. Actually,
but you could take that out anytime you want, right?
Well, it was sort of, you can. It's not as easy, honestly. It's not easy to take out any piercings, frankly, so I refrain from doing it, but I will... The problem comes around children. Like, I hate when people ask questions about piercings or anything. It's just like, maybe the problem is me because I don't want to answer the questions. But it's like, hey, why do you have piercings? Or it's like, just because I like them, but I don't want to deal with the questions. Like, kids' questions are uncomfortable sometimes.
So, but they're usually concealed. I mean, the only way you would get a question about nipple
piercings
is if you were at the beach or something.
I go to the beach. Yeah. You know, I take my shirt off.
That's true.
So, you know, it's something that people are going to ask questions about. They're going to speculate about you. And I don't feel like I should have to take my piercings out every time I'm in public.
Have you ever ruminated about a tattoo, like considered?
Oh, yeah. I'm too much of a wimp. I've been wanting Know Thyself on my left wrist since I was like 18. And I've got a thing about wrists, you know, like cutters and stuff and all that nasty. It just gets me clamped up.
I don't know anything about it. I don't have any tattoos. I don't have any piercings either. I feel very vanilla in comparison.
Come on. Nothing?
It doesn't bother me that I don't. But
don't you want to get one?
No, I've never really felt like I have to have something. You know, like there's never been anything, any symbol or something like that that I've thought, I want to have that on me forever. I've never really felt so strongly about that. And, you know, I feel strongly about the ideas of liberty. I'm sure I could pick one or something like that, but never really, you know, rose to that level.
What
I guess.
About a to-do list on the forearm with lines so you can fill it in every day? I've seen those. That could be useful
it's
for
cute.
Someone like you.
That is cute. But I've got smartphones and things like that. Right. I got the whiteboard that you inspired me to have. So.
Yeah, I think that I think that the envelope's going to continue to get pushed by people who want body modifications in this society or a free one. I don't think it matters. I personally, my piece of advice would be make yourself interesting and unique on the inside.
Yeah.
Do it with if you've got to do it on the outside, do it with clothing and ornamentation. Mm.
You're going to modify yourself, make sure you put a few years into thinking about it. I would say at least 5 years. I would say ruminate on it for 5 years before you really go for something. That way you're sure. Like, you know what you want, you just haven't gone with it yet. And you've known it for a long time. You haven't changed that. To me, that says that's probably the right thing.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Because 5 years, a lot can change, especially if you're a young person, right?
Oh, yeah.
All right, so we'll see you tomorrow night. We'll talk about the college sex thing at another time.
Yeah.
Online in the meantime, freetalklive.com and derekj.me. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Kane in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, September 29th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.58 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,221 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $379. Antiwar.com reports, as the Shiite Houthi movement continues to expand its control over the Yemeni capital of Sana'a, they are quickly attracting the attention of southern Islamist factions, including Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula. Yesterday, a suicide bomber from Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula drove a car bomb into the Houthi-controlled hospital in the Marib province, killing at least 15 people and wounding 50 others, according to the locals. The Yemeni government has sought to keep the Houthis confined to their far north provinces by encouraging Islamist factions to move into the areas near them. After weeks of fighting, the Houthis routed them and moved on to the capital.